Hello. Broadcasting live from beautiful Midtown Manhattan. We're on a clear night, you can almost see Rosie O'Donnell raising her kids straight because it's too hard being a fat bull dyke. It's the Ron and Fez Show, and I'm your announcer, Joe Pooh. And now, let's introduce your hosts. The guys using the weather as an excuse to shoot girls with their water guns. Here they are, Ron Bennington, Fez Watley, Radio Super Soakers.
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified. I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
Buddies! Hey, buddies!
Get in there, buddies!
It's the Ron and Fez Show. I'm Ron Bennington.
What is the correct pronunciation?
With me, as always, is the man who invented hip-hop, Mr. Fez Watley.
Hey!
And he's saying, hey.
Hey, audience!
That just reminds Earl he's got to call his sister. Earl's,
Shaniqua!
You know, oh, which one, he says. You know, we try to teach something every show, and tonight's is...
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
Yes, right out of the speech Billy Staples made yesterday.
From a prepared, apologetic statement, Billy Staples.
Also, so Billy Staples is back on the show.
Radio Insider, Radio Insider, Spy Report, Radio Insider, Spy Report.
But on the other hand, I did find out, I talked to his agent... Blaine Ensley is gone from the radio station. Apparently, in the locker room, he took a batting glove from Opie.
Oh, no.
And attempted to sell it on eBay.
Oh, no. When will they learn?
That's wrong. The locker room, the WNEW locker room, Fezzy.
Yes.
That's a place of sanctuary for us. It's a place of trust.
That clubhouse is a shrine.
Isn't it?
It should be respected. Shrine. It's our fortress of solitude.
The Yankees stealing from each other. How do you deal with that, Earl, as a lifelong Yankees fan?
I hate to see Yankee crime.
How poorly are they paying the young people that they have to steal stuff?
He was making $1 million.
$1 million in that league, and you feel bad, though.
And wasn't he getting, Ruben Rivera, wasn't he getting like $2,500?
Yeah,
for this glove and bat?
He got $2,500.
You know what? If I had $1 million, but I could still pick up a quick $2,500, I'm going to grab it.
It's just disgusting. Now, they say Rivera's wife is calling from Panama, whatever little village they live in there, La Chucaracha or whatever, and she says that people are saying she's married to a thief. And she's trying to make her way through her village.
Yes, she is, though. That's what happens when you steal stuff.
He says he's crying now, Ruben Rivera.
But did he say he didn't take it?
No, he took it, got so upset that he took it, I guess after there was a stink, and it, I guess it took him 2 days to give it back to Jeter.
Jeter needs that. It's a long season.
Jeter was angry with me.
You can't go the whole season without having a glove there. Ruben.
And they were roommates when they were on travel gigs, too.
He says it was all because he was seduced by a memorabilia dealer who handed him $2,500.
This, on the instant feedback from Joe, Blaine stole the wiffle ball bat, used the wiffle ball bat challenge.
and tried to sell it on the eBay.
Smells like a hit.
877-692-1027.
You know, but where is this going to end with Ruben Fezzi?
Yeah, Ruben Rivera.
When's he going to stop this, Mr. Rivera?
I know.
There's other things missing in that locker room.
Right, that's the thing. The Jeter stuff is the only thing he got caught with.
Right.
That's the only thing they've noticed missing so far.
But where's Don Zimmer's crock pot?
I hear that's missing. That is nowhere to be found. I heard Dave Wells' homemade biscuit recipe is missing.
He needs that for his biscuits.
Right. He likes to make homemade biscuits. And without that family recipe, where's that at, Ruben Rivera?
Now, Posada said that he had a Ming vase that was in his locker.
Really?
But I think he's lying.
5,000-year-old Ming dynasty vase?
It was a 5,000... He goes, you didn't... He's saying to everybody, you didn't see it. It was right there in my locker. It was a beautiful Ming vase.
Now, that's wrong. He probably shouldn't keep that. He probably shouldn't keep that in the clubhouse, but no one has the right to take it.
Orlando Hernandez claims he had an autographed picture of Jamie Farr in there that said to El Duque, love ya,
Klinger.
Jamie.
Great. Now, that's missing.
Where's my Klinger picture?
All right. Roger Clemens says he's missing a lot of Blacklight posters. The blacklight is still there.
Right.
But the posters are missing.
One of those, if you stare at them long enough, you can see the Beatles in the volcano.
Oh, really?
The Beatle faces were up against the volcano.
I know there's one of a unicorn that's missing, yeah, and one where the guy's got his head in his hands and his eyeballs melt through, and it just says stoned again.
Now, that was good. Now, Bernie Williams says the snow skis are gone, too.
Now, all right. At spring training, why do you need snow skis?
Well, he said he'd just gotten them waxed.
Oh, okay.
So somebody's paying for that.
All right. Now, Mel Stottlemyre, he says he's missing his bling bling. I don't know exactly what that means, Mel.
That's his bling.
He wants his bling bling.
And he says without that, he doesn't feel like himself. He's got to have his bling on.
Jason Jambi? He's missing his Harry Potter books.
Is that right?
Yeah.
All the ones?
All of them? Goblet of Fire? All of them?
Whole collection? Gone.
Hardback or paperback?
Hardcover.
Oh,
he's
dang.
A serious collector.
Oh, Jesus.
You know, I hate to point fingers.
Oh, Jesus.
I hate to point fingers, but Ruben Rivera, where were you when the Harry Potter books ended up missing? That's the sad thing.
I didn't even know he could read.
He can read. What about Robin Ventura's Tybo videos?
Oh,
did they
yeah.
show up at all?
He needs those. He needs to work out.
He says that he doesn't even know he's working out until he's done.
Really?
Yeah, then he's just sweating.
Now, Alfonso Soriano...
He says it's more fun than a workout.
Really?
He loves the Tybo.
I gotta try it. Alfonso Soriano, he says he's missing his collection of snow globes.
All right, so he needs that back.
Right. So that's something I know...
Rivera! All right, if you don't have it, let me pat you down.
Mm-hmm.
I said, Ruben, let me go through your pockets. If you don't have it, then I'm wrong.
Sure. But that's something he's had since he was a kid.
All right, Andy Pettit is missing a Blockbuster card.
Ooh.
And apparently he was supposed to get a free one pretty soon, too.
All right. Now, see, someone could be checking out videos, DVDs, and games on his plan.
Hey, Joe. Joe, you're on Red Fez.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, guys, I got a spy report.
Oh, good. I'm glad to hear one.
Spy report. Spy report.
Joe reported his first baseman missing. It turns out that Rivera admitted to stealing Tino Martinez and selling him to St. Louis.
All right, see, that's wrong. We need Tino back.
Right.
Does he?
If
you
know Ruben took Tino.
No matter how he's hitting, the girls like him.
Sure. He's eye candy out there.
Yeah,
he's eye candy. At the very least. Now, Nick Johnson, he says his pet lemur was stolen.
He had a pet lemur?
He had a pet lemur. And that is gone. And unfortunately, all signs point towards Ruben Rivera.
Why wouldn't they? Now, Mike Messina says his air supply records are missing.
Really? Now, at first thought, you would think, who would want them? But maybe this is just a sickness with this Ruben Rivera.
They were signed, Fuzzy.
Oh.
Who wouldn't want signed air supply?
By Russell Hitchcock. Gee whiz.
That's so faggy, you know that. That's so incredibly faggy.
Speaking of which, Sterling Hitchcock says his cameo brooch is missing.
My brooch!
My brooch!
Apparently the lights went off, and when it came back on, he screamed, my brooch.
And it was gone.
Right. And so was Ruben.
Right. And Ruben Rivera, nowhere to be found.
Someone left a Ruben sandwich behind. I think that's his calling card.
Like he's the Riddler.
Whenever he takes something, he just leaves a Ruben sandwich.
Half eaten, though.
Sure.
877-692-1027.
Here is, I can't even, I'm not even getting names. I got a drunk on the line right there. Hi, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah.
Yo.
Yeah.
What's up? I heard Rondell White's missing his towel.
He's got to have his tail. He got to have his tail so he can damp it off that moisture.
Now, on my list.
It stops up the moisture.
Now, on my list of things missing, Rondell White's reporting also a Santa costume.
Really?
Yes.
Well, and he does that for the kids.
Right, uh-huh.
He does that for the kids.
Uh-huh. And stores it in Florida.
Yes, he stores it.
During the off season.
Hey, Carla. Carla, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, Carla.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hey, Carlholder 1369.
Hoo-ah,
hoo-ah. George Steinbrenner is missing all of his satin clip-on ties.
See, that's bad. He needs those.
He needs those.
He likes to look classy.
And his short sleeve button shirts.
Right. See you later. That is a good look, though, in the summer.
Yeah. Now, third base coach Willie Randolph, he claims to be missing some porno mags. He's looking for porno mags. I don't know if they were stolen or he's just looking for porno mags.
No, he said he had jugs.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
Okay.
He had jugs and barely legal teens. Hey, Chris. Chris, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah, hey, listen, I heard that Bernie Williams had a collector's edition of cue cards for his LASIK surgery commercials that were lost.
Ruben! Ruben, get your ass in here.
Ruben Rivera, can we please check the trunk of your car?
All they found was a little Ruben sandwich left behind. That's his calling card.
I think it's a clue.
I know it's a clue. He's laughing at us. That's what drives me crazy.
Now, I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing, but Mariano Rivera is missing a girl suit he was making out of actual human flesh.
He was getting that from fat girls.
Yes.
She a great big fat girl.
And cutting it out in diamond shapes on their back.
Sure.
So that's probably good that that's missing.
I don't know. Steve, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, guys. I was advised Shane Spence is missing his George Foreman grilling machine.
All right, now he needs that
right,
for his chicken.
Yeah, that drains the fat.
It drains the fat.
It really does.
Because a lot of chicken's too fatty, right, George?
It comes with its own little gutter, its own little rain gutter that catches all the fat.
Won't eat that half Reuben sandwich that was left behind.
That's evidence.
As a calling card.
877-692-1027. This is just wrong.
Yeah.
What's happening at the Yankee Clubhouse.
Jose, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Jose. Doing, guys.
Yeah.
I swear to God, I didn't know this was Little League Baseball. He stole my glove. I mean, honestly, Derek Jeter has enough money to just say, like, oh, I lost my glove. Buy another one.
Yeah, but do you want to get a glove a day? And I'm we're working here. If someone takes change out of your pants, that's wrong.
True, very true.
There's got to be honor among men.
Earl sneaks into our office to steal gum, and we're furious.
The man could buy himself a gold.
Wait, he's not saying he doesn't have money. All right, here's Earl with it.
No, they're saying it's the principle of the thing because you spend like 6 to 7 months with...
trying to work your glove in.
Yeah, not only that, but you're just spending all this time with these guys and it's kind of like a violation. It's, if you violate...
Sure.
It's like today it's a glove, tomorrow it could be a watch.
And tomorrow it's taking photos while they're in the shower.
Right, they're taking pictures of dinks.
You think that could really happen?
And you know, things can happen. Years ago, someone stole Thurman Munson's flight plan.
Right.
Look what happened there. All right, there's not enough time yet, Earl? Enough time hasn't passed? Well, like 25 years.
Yeah.
I mean, we do Buddy Holly jokes. Everybody laughs. Everybody loves it. That's still not enough time.
Wow. I could have sworn enough time had passed.
I thought, you know...
Someone checked the joke calendar.
Well, tragedy plus time is normally 20 years.
Uh-huh. I'm just now getting in some Lindbergh baby jokes.
Now?
Yeah. Because of this thing. The calendar's all off.
Hey, Tommy. Tommy, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Tommy.
Hi, fellas.
Yeah.
David Wells is missing a gallon jar of his blue cheese dressing. Can't finish his chicken wings.
He's starving. Hey, I have a prediction.
All right.
David Wells becomes the newest collection, part of the Ed Trunk Rat Pack, of hanging down here playing metal music.
Oh.
Because he's a big metal fan.
That makes perfect sense.
I'm telling you, it's going to happen. Mark it down, Joe.
I got it right here. David Wells listening to Metallica with Eddie.
Here is...
Earl says he thinks Giambi, too.
Again with Giambi?
Giambi's a big metalhead, too.
I can't have this place packed on Friday nights. We got a lights-out parties.
We got things going on. You get Wells in here. Finally, right. Trunk's got someone to make him look thin.
All right, Brian said, according to the show... That's mean. According to the show South Park, the official amount of time till something is funny is 22.5 years.
Oh, okay.
And I think we covered that on the Thurman Munson, right?
Yeah, Thurman.
Yet I warn you now, don't do a space shuttle joke. It's not enough time.
Right, that's 86.
Yeah.
Not there yet.
No.
Mm-mm. Not even close.
But feel free to do any jokes about Leonard Skinner's plane going down.
Okay.
Plenty of time.
So what year was it 22 years ago? Someone do the math.
80. How hard's that?
But really, it may vary.
But they're actually saying midway through 79.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. So,
we can start doing hostage jokes.
The Iranian hostage jokes.
And then any of that Kool-Aid jokes, I think, was actually the day after. Jonestown.
Oh, yeah. Jim Jones.
Yeah.
Giving Kool-Aid to the cult.
I thought he gave them to the Colts, and I thought that's why they left Baltimore.
They had to.
Is that enough time with the Colts leaving Baltimore that we can start joking?
I think.
Because I know you still can't do Dodgers leaving Brooklyn jokes without someone taking a swing at you. Cecil, you're on Rent-A-Fest. How are you?
Hey, Cecil.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Cecil, where's Beanie Boy?
Hey, listen, I heard Gary Condit's missing an intern. Ruben Rivera stole her, I think.
All right, here's the thing. Gary Condit's not on the Yankees, okay? So let's stay in the framework of the joke, okay? The reason why these jokes work, we set up a framework, didn't we, Fez?
Yes, a very nice framework.
Right.
That left a lot of room inside.
Plenty of room. You had 30 names, at least, you could throw into these jokes, and it's fun.
Right. In baseball terms, we left a very big strike zone. Very
right.
Generous.
From armpits to the knees, really.
So, please, people, focus. That's all we ask.
Tony, you're on the fence.
Hey, Tony.
What's up, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, I heard he stole Rowley Fingers' mustache wax.
All right, well, let's look around. What year is it, Tony?
I know. I was trying to be cool.
But that's not going to work for you.
All right, here's a better one.
No, wait. I just want you to learn because we set up a framework.
Hey, you said Thurman Munson.
No, I said somebody years ago did that.
Okay.
I never said that Ruben did because obviously he wasn't around then. He would be a child at best.
All right, right. I'm a retard. I'm sorry.
It doesn't make you retarded. You just don't understand the framework that we set up.
The way that it works. The blueprint that we give you to follow.
Give me one more shot and I'll punch out.
Yeah.
How about he stole David Cohen's bullpen splooge gel?
Again, you're looking too far away.
Right.
And he yells F you at us on the way out.
He does a joke about mustache wax and says, I just wanted to be cool.
Right. And then he yells F you when we're trying to be his buddy. Do we have to reband Tony? Reband him?
Ban him.
Reband.
Reband.
Reband. Ruben, reband.
Stand behind the ass, man. You're on the reband line.
And we don't care how long that line gets.
Yeah. And another thing, kids...
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
It's never justified.
Ever. There is no way to justify it.
Like Jeremy said to me in the hotel, that belongs in the toilet and nowhere else.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't think I had to put it in the memo. I go, why bring it up to me, Jeremy?
Again, paying for other people's mistakes.
Right. I work with these guys. I'm not in charge of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The fact that you have to see a memo stating these things.
Andrew, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Andrew.
What's up, guys? Yeah. Cardholder 707.
Hoo-ah. All right, my friend.
Yeah, I heard someone stole Joe Torre's ass cancer.
Okay, enough time to do an ass cancer joke?
No.
Yeah.
But about here's, no right. Drama.
Here's what my thing. Anytime someone brings up ass cancer, I wonder if I have it. Because are you supposed to feel it?
It's itchy.
It is?
All right, then I might have something.
I might have it then.
It's got to be worse symptoms than just itching.
Mostly itching.
Bad itching.
Scratchy itching.
All right, now I think I got it in my sack. Let's move to the front.
Great. Now, according to Joe Torre, Ruben Rivera stole his innocence. And I don't even know what that means.
Well, I know he yelled, "This is the end of my innocence."
Oh, okay.
Tony, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, Tony.
Hey, former Yankee pitcher Jim Abbott stopped by to say hello to the boys.
Yeah.
When he left, his hand was missing.
All right, see, now, here's a good thing. He put it in the framework by saying he stopped by.
Right.
That worked out.
It's current again.
Right, if Tony would have said, hey, at the old-timers game, he stole Raleigh Fingers' mustache wax, he wouldn't be on the reband list.
No cowbell?
No, you're not going to get cowboy.
No, not for that. Well, we thank you for working with Inside the Framework.
Right.
You brought him into the Yankee clubhouse where things have been stolen.
Well, here's the thing that we're trying to push here. Unlike other shows, Fez and I like to have a framework. Mm-hmm. A framework, Fezzy, of reference. Comedic reference.
Right. That way boundaries are set.
Right.
And it makes it easy for you, the audience, the participating callers, to know your boundaries. And to work inside.
Right. Or else it would just be a catch-as-catch-can hodgepodge of jokes.
Oh, there'd be jokes coming in every which way.
We don't need that. This way, we've got a perfect framework, and we line up each joke in a line across, starting from the left, moving to the right, and as soon as we fill up one line, we move down one.
And that way, we avoid what we call chaos.
Right.
The chaos theory.
Now, hopefully, at the end of the segment, we'll have perfectly lined up jokes.
Mm-hmm. From the coaching staff, to the pitching staff, the infielders, the outfielders, everything will be covered inside the framework.
And if this framework holds strong, Fezzy, and I hope it will, we're already part of a best-of segment.
There you go.
That's all I want, for each segment to have their opportunity to make a best-of.
We start with a simple framework. By the end of the segment, we hope to have a strong foundation for a best-of segment.
Yeah. Now, we learned a lot of this from the Egyptians.
Mm-hmm.
Who better? Who better building a pyramid, Fezzy? And what I'd like to say is, this is a pyramid of comedy.
Sure. It's a pyramid theory.
Right. Now, what I'm asking you, at the top of our pyramid of comedy, do you want the word ass cancer there? I don't think so.
Probably not.
No.
Why should that top off anyone's pyramid?
No.
That's more of a base joke, where you're setting a base.
Right.
And build your pyramid on.
Right. But what I hope, somewhere at the top of the pyramid, and we'll know that we've totally built it, we've worked Mookie Wilson into the jokes.
Nice. Okay. That's our goal.
I'm hoping. All right. Jim, you're on Run a Fez.
Thank you for the end of the innocence, Earl.
Yeah.
Hello
there. Always feel free to throw in Henley. I love it.
Hi, Jim.
Hello there. I think Roger Clemens is missing his Mike Piazza autographed baseball card.
Okay.
No. It's in there.
Yeah. All right, thanks.
Okay.
Because it's in the framework, but...
Yeah. But if we're looking at the pyramid theory, that's base at best.
Right. Robert.
You're not even on an incline. Hi, Robert.
Robert, welcome to the Framework of Comedy. How are you, my friend?
Hey, Ron and Fez. How are you?
Yeah.
Phil Rizzuto's missing his cow.
The holy cow?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You know what we might have to do if this makes the best of? Just take that out.
Right, yeah.
Take that out. Put that with the Tony bit. And take me talking about the Tony bit and this bit out, because obviously...
Because at this early stage of a bit, you don't want to compromise the framework.
Right.
Because then it leads to trouble and collapse.
Right. I'll tell you the truth, I'm not even happy with this foundation. I'm thinking about digging it back up. Jim, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Jim.
Hey, Ron Fez.
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, I was just talking to El Duque, and his raft is missing.
Okay, now I feel like we're back in where we belong. Okay, we got Al Duque's rafted. And then we can laugh, really, when we think about it, of other people that are starving and trying to get to this country on rafts.
Sure.
And we can feel superior to them because we were born here and we're all overweight. So it's great.
And we can dedicate these sort of things like to Elian Gonzalez's mother.
And then laugh and point at that.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because that didn't happen to us.
Oh, right, yeah. We wouldn't be caught dead.
Right, because you don't need...
Literally.
You don't need the 22.5 years when it happens to a minority.
Mm-hmm.
Those jokes immediately become funny.
Yeah, the joke calendar. You just throw months.
Right.
Months and years off
right.
of there.
Mike. Mike, you're on Runnifest.
Hello, Mike. Mike. You there, buddy? No, Mike.
That's messing up the framework. And I'm still hoping to get to a Mookie Wilson joke for the top of the pyramid. I don't know how we're going to get there. I'm a little nervous. John. John, you're on Runnifest.
Hey, John.
What's up, boys?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, buddy.
Yo, I just heard on the ESPN bottom line that Ruben Rivera got arrested for stealing a lawnmower from the grounds crew for his next job.
All right, now, I love that you brought in ESPN. That made it more believable.
Bottom line is such a funny little phrase in
right.
its own
take it
right.
Easy, guys.
The only problem is, what if we would have had one of those guys' actual names? From the
oh,
ground
right, yeah. Then the head groundsman.
Right,
then, or whatever.
Then you got a perfect joke.
Yeah.
Then we're going places.
Yeah, Sully Farvis at Yankee Stadium.
Right. Hey, John, you're on Manifest.
Hello, John.
Hey, how you doing? Hey. I heard Andy Pettit lost his relationship with Jesus.
Okay, here's what I like about that. I'll tell you why. It gives us a chance to laugh at Andy Pettit, and also it's a chance to put Jesus' name in the joke without doing a Jesus joke.
Right, yeah, that one. Yeah.
The joke's on Andy Pettit, not on the Lord and Savior.
No, uh-uh. That way, I feel like maybe this segment and this framework has gotten a bit of a blessing.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
All right. See you later.
Later.
Hey, Jim. Jim, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, Jim.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, Giuliani is missing his fat kid.
All right. The problem there is Giuliani's kid is now 6'2 and like 150. So he's a big, strong boy now.
And you're stepping way outside the framework.
Normally the term fat kid would make everybody laugh, though. So I like that attitude.
It's as catchy a phrase as bottom line.
Yeah. Hey, Jerry. Jerry, you're on Runnifest.
Hello, Jerry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got two beauties for you.
All right.
Somebody stole the Bat Boy's virginity.
Somebody stole.
Somebody. All right, remember, this all starts with Ruben Rivera.
Exactly.
Who is the known Yankee thief at
right.
this point.
All right, what else?
Okay.
And if we had the Bat Boy's name.
I'm telling you right now.
Okay.
The framework is coming,
I'll tell you
coming
what,
down.
Try it again, but say Danny Almonte.
Yeah, try that, yeah.
Okay, somebody stole Danny Almonte's virginity.
All right, are you saying somebody?
Who? Right.
We've got to hear...
Ruben.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ruben Rivera. Try it all the way from the beginning now, Jer.
Jer, you're on with Ron and Fez. We're going to clean this up for the best of.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ruben Rivera stole Danny Almonte's virginity.
That's great.
That's great.
That's great.
Okay, you want to hear the beauty?
Oh, that we got a beauty over that? Yeah, all right, let's hear the beauty.
Somebody stole Daryl Strawberry's hollowed out Buddha.
All right, somebody. Again, it's with the somebody. Jerry, we're going to let you go here.
Jim,
we've got a destroyed framework.
There's only so many chances we can give, much like the Yankees themselves, to Ruben Rivera.
Hey, Ron and Fez, I heard somebody stole something from some other guy.
And they took it.
Yeah, and I think it was a colored guy.
That's all I know so far.
Anyway, spread that joke around. It's going places. Hey, Dogman. Dogman, you're on Run and Fez. By the way, what we're really looking for is that Mookie Wilson joke.
5967.
And I'm starting to be afraid we're not going to get to it.
Hoo-ah!
Go ahead, Dogman.
Somebody stole Lou Gehrig's lymph nodes and Ty Cobb's ice pack.
All right, now we've moved into a constant somebody.
Mm-hmm.
What happened to this beautiful bit we were in doing?
We started it all out with Ruben Rivera.
Yeah.
Who, you know what? You can't go wrong with, he's a known thief.
Right.
He admitted to it.
Yes.
He gave back the stolen property. No one's going to be upset if we say Ruben Rivera.
You know what the ice pack's for?
Yeah, go ahead.
It's for icing his hand down after beating his wife after hitting the flask. See ya!
Okay, that part was funny. That part was very funny.
I thought for sure he was just going to go simply with balls. It was for his balls.
Is that basically for icing his balls on his face? Can you imagine?
I would have accepted either balls or his hand for smacking his wife around after hitting the flask.
Hey, Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Mike.
Hey, I understand a truckload of Reggie bars was just hijacked.
By who?
By his cousin.
<You're> not... this is falling apart.
Call the building inspector, because we got no framework.
I was hoping that this would actually make it to a best of. I'm thinking about punching out and just throwing a best of on now and using up a best of.
At this point, we're nowhere near a Mookie Wilson joke. We're nowhere near. We're starting from the bottom up at this point.
Hey, Tommy. Tommy, you're on Run a Fest.
Hey, guys. I heard I was watching ESPN.
You were? When?
Yeah,
when were you watching it?
They said that, you know, believe it or not, it's such a sad story.
Oh, it is.
Ruben Rivera, he stole the spooky out of Mookie.
That's not it.
That is not the pinnacle of our pyramid.
White people are so scared of black people.
And how are we going to have that song in a best of situation? That means something's went terribly wrong. Hey, Joe. Joe, you're on Run a Fest.
Go ahead, Joe.
How you doing, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, I was just on eBay, and I see that Ruben Rivera is selling a plate. And then I went over to ESPN.com.
Yeah.
Find out Don Zimmer is missing the plate from his head.
So there could be a tie-in.
I think there might be.
All right.
Thank you for coming back home to the framework.
Yeah, we're back in the framework.
Welcome home.
Although, you know, there's not a, it's not a happy framework anymore, Fez.
We're CBS. Welcome home.
Welcome home. There used to be jokes here. All right, here is Anthony. Anthony, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, Anthony.
Hey, guys. How you doing tonight?
Okay.
Chuck Knobloch called in. He wants to know how Ruben Rivera ever stole his ability to throw to first base.
That's kind of cute, and it's, you know, it could have happened somehow.
It's doable in the framework.
Sure.
Completely doable.
Hey, Anthony. Anthony, you're on Run and Fez.
Yeah, how you doing, Ron? How are you?
Yeah, we're okay, Anthony. Nice to talk to you, buddy.
It's good to hear that.
Yeah.
Well, the story I got over the AP was that Garrett Morris, Mookie Wilson stole Garrett Morris's baseball bin, very, very good routine.
That is so retarded.
Is it?
It's so retarded.
I'm working so hard on it, too.
No, you had the AP, which I loved, but then we took Ruben Rivera out of the situation, and then we're bringing up a 30-year-old Garrett Morris bit.
But did you get to the top of the $100,000 pyramid?
No, not yet, but thank you.
Jesus Christ.
The $100,000 pyramid.
I'm ready to take Tony's ban off.
You know what
I'm ready to unban Tony and let him back in.
What I love is a fine, upstanding citizen like Mookie Wilson was now known as the thief in that last joke. Played the part of the criminal.
All right, so the same thing happened here, Fezzy. We lost Blaine for stealing stuff from Opie. Stole Opie's glove.
Yeah, that story can finally be told. That's why Blaine's no longer with the sports guys.
Wow.
Thievery in the locker room here at WNEW.
Hey, Justin. Justin, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, Justin.
Hey, guys. 1557.
All right, buddy.
I heard that Ruben Rivera was over in Port St. Lucie, and now Eddie Trunk's not getting a wedding gift. I'm getting you closer to Mookie Wilson. You're in the clubhouse.
All right, thanks. Piazza's there. All right, Cancer Mike writes in. He says Ruben Rivera stole second base. Literally.
Nice. By the way, Earl, how was Eddie Trunk's wedding?
You didn't go?
No.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I thought you would have.
That's too bad.
You should have been there, my friend.
Yeah. Eddie back this week?
No. He took 2 weeks.
He's got a nice job, doesn't he? He works 2 days a week, but he takes 4 days off in 2 weeks.
You know, he could just take the time off that he normally gets during the week, and that would have been a honeymoon. The weekend and the 4 days that he has off.
To me, it seems to me he gets a vacation a week. Every week seems like, oh, great. Now I got a week off. Yeah. I don't have to be back here for a week.
Talk about a guy who's just phoning it in anymore.
Talk about a station that's just phoning it in. Hey, Matt. Matt, you're on Ron and Fez. Hey, Matt.
Hey, he stole Mookie Wilson's literacy.
I actually would have went with that if you just didn't say he.
Oh, come on. At the old-timers game, Ruben Rivera stole his literacy.
All right, that would have been better. All right, thank you, my friend.
The thing is, though, once you have an education, that's something no one can take from you.
Really?
Not even Ruben Rivera. That's the statement I'd like to make.
Stay in school, kids.
Please. And welcome home to CBS.
No, I'm not breaking, Earl. Yeah. I'm not breaking until I get to the top of the joke pyramid.
You think we're going to leave a pyramid unbuilt? Please.
All right, here's...
Walking out on the job like Moses?
Yes.
Leaving a pyramid half done?
Moses was a slacker who would rather walk around the desert than finish his job. All right, here's, you know, I feel good about this.
Moses, Aaron, Miriam, I put them all in there.
We said at the top of the pyramid of this beautiful bit of comedy that literally we created out of thin air for everybody.
Right.
We wanted a Mookie Wilson joke at the top. Mm.
That's all we asked
That's
for.
That's all we asked for. Paul Bond is going to go for it, Fezzy.
All right.
I wish him all the best. Maybe we can even just get, like, off announcers here and say, Paul Bond, going for the top of the pyramid. We hope him nothing but the best here.
All right. We're going to go to the phone.
We noticed more and more times people went for the Mookie Wilson. Never stood a chance. Paul Bond, going for the joke from airsick.net. That would put him at the top of the pyramid of some of the funniest comedy done in the last half hour.
Paul Bond, a chance to be the hero or the goat here tonight.
Paul Bond, of course, been on the road doing comedy for the last several weeks, Fez. Mm-hmm.
Opening for Jim Brewer.
Opening for Jim Brewer and also part of that rock band that he has. And a lot of excitement around that big special coming out on the Comedy Network.
Mm-hmm.
And we got Paul Bond.
All right. Paul Bond.
Going for the joke. Paul, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Try to hit it, baby.
Ruben Rivera stole back his color TV from Mookie Wilson.
We got it! Thank Christ! Thank Christ! He stole it back! He stole it back!
Wow!
All right, thank you so much, Paul.
Nice to be of help.
All right, but you also get, but also you're going to get this.
White people are so scared of black people.
We'll take a break like Earl wants, and like he keeps yelling, we're late! It is the Ron and Fez show.
Ron Fez, 1027 WNEW.
I'll be playing the part of Pharrell.
And we're trying to order food in the restaurant. Excuse me, waitress, I'd like...
Pharrell needs some menu right now. Pharrell's got to get a menu. He got some TV appetizers. Maybe a soup of the day. I'll tell you what, what's your entree today? You got any specials going? I need food, 100 miles an hour. Here we go. And don't forget the dessert. I'm taking a chocolate mousse. Maybe we'll do that. And then an espresso, because I need energy. Go 100 miles an hour.
Sports in the Morning with Pharrell. Tomorrow, live at 545, 1027. WNEW. Ron and Fez, 1027 WNEW.
We're Ron and Fez. Ron Bennington, Fez Whiteley with you on a Thursday.
Fezzy, we're going over some of the Yankee jokes and which ones are okay to do. Heckler sent this to us, and it's a good rule of thumb for us to use in the future. You get a pass on Munson, you're able to do Munson jokes now. Billy Martin jokes, always funny.
Okay.
Mantle's liver? No.
Oh, all right.
Strawberry Gooden? Sure. Go ahead, help yourself. Tori and Stoudemire's cancer jokes? No.
Oh, okay.
Steve Howe rehab? First four times, no. Last three, yeah. Go ahead.
All right, at that point, sure.
Yeah. So I think that's a good rule of thumb as we're entering the baseball season to know what we can get away with this year.
That's a nice little handbook that everyone should carry around with them.
And then as far as the Mets go, do any joke you want. They're all funny. They all work.
Please feel free. 877-692-1027.
Hey, Gadget, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, what's up? I just called you guys to invite you to the Blade 2 movie release party at Webster Hall.
All right, Fezzy. Blade 2 release party. Now, who's all going to be there? Would you say this is going to be a star-studded evening?
There's rumors to such. I can't confirm or deny them, though.
Wesley?
I cannot say that.
Chris?
Prince?
Christopherson.
Oh, it's going to be knife throwing.
Hey, here's what I understand. I saw Chris Christopherson in the Blade 2 preview. I thought he died in the first one.
Yeah, how does that work?
Oh, don't tell me he's a vampire now.
I hope not.
Oh, poor Chris.
He's a vampire killer.
Well, there's going to be knife throwing going on. There's going to be a fashion show.
All right. Is this open to the general public?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, well, then what's the big deal about me and Fez being invited?
Well, we want to invite you guys for free because we like you, and we wanted to thank you for giving us the laughs all these years.
All right. What, you're in a band?
Yes.
All right, go ahead, plug your band. That's what this is about.
No, actually, it's not, but if you want to give me the opportunity, I'll take it. It's Otto'sDaughter.com.
Otto'sDaughter.com.
Yeah, and we're playing there that night. I'd still rather
now, there's a
have
girl?
You guys come down.
There's a girl singer. Is that why you're Otto's daughter?
Yep.
Ah,
okay.
And her dad's name is Otto?
Absolutely.
Otto Preminger.
I'd love to see this.
Yes, and
man.
He's German.
All right. Okay, Otto'sDaughter.com. All right, buddy.
You got to call your band Blade 2. More people want to see it.
Thanks.
You think that's going to be big, Fez? Blade 2?
Yeah, Blade 2 is going
to
rock.
Hey, don't forget to tell Billy Staples. It's open bar from 11 to midnight. All right, guys. Thanks so much.
Yeah, he'll break you. He'll break that movie. I don't care how much they bring in. Although Billy did have to say this a couple of times to be okay to with the company.
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
Under any circumstances.
Yeah.
You can't joke with that stuff.
Yeah, you can't. It's not a laugh-filled time for you, Billy.
So Billy's back on board. There's a drunk back at the phones.
Good.
And all seems right with the world.
The person you're trying to reach is drunk. Please try your call again.
And from what I understand, ladies, he's single. We kid you not, last night, nothing has been done to this. Billy's standing here at the microphone last night. This is the sound that comes out of his stomach. We're not making this up, and also it hasn't even been raised up in volume.
Right.
This is exactly what it sounded like. Now, what human makes it sound like that?
That thing actually gurgled right out of his gullet. That wasn't a burp. It didn't come out of his mouth. It came, like, right through him.
Now, here's something when he was drunk. This came out of his mouth. Now we're coming out of his stomach. When we get to the ass, we may have to quit.
Mm-hmm.
We are frightened what this thing is eventually going to sound like when it explodes out of his ass.
All right, Ronnie, give me the churning again.
Okay.
I have finally identified the sound.
Uh-huh.
I knew it sounded like something.
Yeah.
At first, I said nocturnal sloth.
Right.
Some sort of nighttime predator.
Sure.
If you listen to it again, did you see the movie Contact?
Yeah.
It's the signal that Jodie Foster is hearing in Contact. From Vega. Billy's making that exact same sound.
Let me ask you this, Fez. And maybe you'll need to shut your eyes for this one so you understand it.
Okay.
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
We know.
I recognize that one.
But let's go back to this. Did you see Starship Troopers, the brain bug?
Oh, yeah.
Where they look like they just had a big vag on the end of them.
And they gave it a big probe at the end of that film.
Hey, Joe, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm a paramedic, and...
I think it's remarkable that you're able to get around.
I know.
Because I couldn't do it. I need my legs.
To be wheelchair.
But I
you're
guess,
brave.
I
you're
guess
brave, sir.
You can use your arms?
No, paramedic, not...
Yes,
paramedic.
Yes, you are. You're brave.
Mm-hmm. And you can still play basketball, can't you? They just lower the basket.
Although they all travel.
Yeah,
they can't walk, but they constantly travel.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Exactly.
All right, what can we do for you, Joe?
The only thing I've ever heard that sounds like that is like a sucking chest wound when somebody gets stabbed or shot.
All right.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. All right, thanks a lot.
All right.
What exactly is a sucking chest wound?
I guess once you get stabbed, the air is going in. So it starts to suck in air, which can't be good for you.
No. You never want to have too much air in your system.
If you hear this coming out of your gullet, call a doctor.
Please. And then says,
I'm sorry, there's nothing I can do about it.
Right. Here's what would be scary. you got a sucking chest wound.
Uh-huh.
And then paramedics show up to help you. They can't even walk. Mm-hmm. I'd like to say, thank you for your help. Use your cell phone and call walking people.
With my last breath, I would be saying, I should be helping you.
That's so good of you. Seriously, that is.
But, you know, they're handicapable, yeah, the paramedics.
They're good. Handicapable, what's that mean, Fez?
They're not handicapped. They're handicapable.
All right, so you're now saying the opposite of capped is capable.
Uh-huh. Exactly. Capped infers limitations. We've put a cap on that.
Right.
Can't go any farther. Capable. You're capable of anything.
Right. That's like saying you're 82 years young. You know, say whatever you want.
Still the first day of the rest of your life.
Well, that one does make sense. Hey, Tony, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Tony.
Buddies.
Yeah.
What at?
Yo, I know what Billy Staples' growl sounds like.
What's that?
It's the janitor on The Simpsons when he gets his wolves out and they start growling at the kids and stuff. That's it. That's
how the
one.
Hell? Willie the janitor.
What is going on inside Staples' body that's the sounds he's making?
He tried to pass it off to us as, you know, he's had the stapling people. So he said that it was fluid finally passing out of his stapled pouch and into his stomach.
So sick.
Like when you got a clogged up sink and finally the thing just goes on you.
Essentially.
Just finally lets loose down the drain.
Essentially, his staples are queefing.
Essentially, sure. If we're going to start using medical terms, yes.
Wow, that may be the only actual recording of a belly queef.
Here is Ken. Ken, you're on Manifest.
Yes, Ken.
Hey, what's up, Manifest?
What?
Hey, card number 10577.
That's a fine one.
I think the noise is Al Dukes biting the pillow.
Again, I think someone's on to something there. I think he's humping that pillow.
People are writing in asking how to get a hold of Jesus is a Way Cool Guy. Wasn't that John S. Hall at AOL?
Yep, that's exactly what it was.
Yeah, and he's got all kinds of poetry things coming up, and he's reading, and he started a law firm, and he's in a play, and he's got a band concert.
I think he has like 50 things that he's doing tomorrow night alone.
Right. And then Fez looked at him and said, I'm taping Tough Enough too, which...
And he didn't seem impressed.
Yeah. Hey, Randy. Randy, you're on Runafest.
Yo, what's up, guys?
Hi, Randy.
Big ass car 307 here.
That's a great one.
Hoo-ah!
Yo, I've heard that noise before. Whenever I touch the sides in Operation, that's what came out.
Oh, on the show Operation?
No. That little game, I think it was.
Right.
Oh.
Well, maybe it was the show. I don't know. I heard it a lot.
Ha, ha, ha. Remo Funny Bone. But don't touch the sides.
Do you ever have that game?
Yeah.
You can barely set it off. You're sitting there hammering against the end, and you can't get that thing going.
I thought, here's a great game for kids. It's a naked guy, and you're picking things with him. You're picking things out of his crotch.
Fez, as a four-year-old, got caught giving skull to the Operation game.
I had gotten a very bad shock, is what happened, and they found me there. I forgot to take the batteries out.
Sure.
The guy's nose was lit up.
Yeah.
My balls were. It was a mess.
There was a sound coming out of your balls.
Fortunately, a man in a wheelchair showed up. He said he was a paramedic.
That's sad, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I'd kill myself. Joey, you're on Runafez.
Hey, that's the exact sound that Mookie Wilson made when Ruben Rivera stole his TV.
Okay, we're done with that, okay? The framework has been taken care of. Hey, Mick. Mick, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Mick. Mick.
Yo, Manifest.
Yeah. There you go, buddy.
Hey, what's happening, bro? Hey, you know that sound from Billy Staples' gut sounds exactly like Roseanne out with a girlfriend for lunch there. You know, I mean, it's unbelievable.
Roseanne doesn't have a girlfriend.
Rosie does.
Roseanne here, there, everywhere, you know what I mean?
Mick,
get around.
How were you able to dial us? Who helped you?
Well, you know, I got to dial us.
Did you have to call the paramedics to dial the phone?
Well, you know,
All right, we can't just hear. We can't do callbacks to every joke that didn't work out. I am seriously trying to get a show started here tonight. I'm doing everything I can to bring comedy to the tri-state area. I want some help.
The man calls in with a Rosie O'Donnell joke, sets his own framework, and then violates it.
By calling her Roseanne.
Roseanne's girlfriend.
Yeah. So stupid. Hey, Chris, you're on Runafus.
Hi, Chris.
Hey, what's up? When a car overheats, the hot radiator makes the same sound.
Ooh, let's try that.
Maybe Billy was overheating. We need to get some coolant in him.
Yeah. Hey, Greg. Greg, you're on Runafus.
Hey, Greg.
Hey, gosh, how you doing?
Yeah.
It's been a while, but isn't that the sound that Kubert made when he died?
Didn't he kind of suck into himself there? That right. is the real thing coming out of Billy's stomach. Well, this is Billy. And he really gets going sexually.
All over me. All over me.
That's strange, isn't it, Fez?
That needs to be studied.
Yeah.
By zoologists. By people at some sort of animal clinic.
You don't think so? You're saying he's not human at this point?
No, and I say take it beyond veterinarians. Actually, give it to a zoologist.
Now, is that maybe a higher up position?
Yeah, I think so.
So to be a zoologist, you have to have more schooling than a veterinarian.
I would say yes. I think you got to know more things to be a zoologist.
What do you think is the highest position you have in animal work?
In animal work, zoologist. I'm gonna say. Marine biologist.
Yeah.
Marine biologist.
That's the big daddy of them all, isn't it?
That is. That's what you shoot for.
Right. I would only want to work with mammals of the sea. Mm. I would make a point of that.
At the very top, you got marine biologist.
Yeah.
Very bottom, I would say either those dog walkers you see on the east side.
There's like 12 of them at the same time.
Or maybe someone who house sits for you and feeds your cat while you're going on vacation. That's probably at the bottom.
Any point that a human has to go over someone else's to take care of an animal. It's going to make you seem like an animal.
I had to do that one time. I told a friend I would.
Yeah.
I went over there twice. Once at the beginning of the week, poured out like the whole big bag of cat food, and then went back at the end of the week.
and
true story.
And cleaned up the dead cat. Hey, Jim, you're on Runafus.
Cat was fine.
Yes, I heard Melissa fantasizing about me.
Let me see.
All over me.
Oh, that's my Melissa.
There it is.
All over me.
All right, hold on. You are a lucky winner, my friend.
There's the winning cowbell, Jim. You're going to the big-ass prize closet to get a four-pack of WWF tickets to the Continental Airlines Arena. That's for Thursday, the 28th of March. It's Hollywood Hogan, Scott Hall, and Kevin Nash making their NWO debut at the first WWF Continental Airlines Arena date of the year. Tickets still available at the box office, all Ticketmaster locations. And Ticketmaster.
For life.
And Ticketmaster.com.
We're old order for life. When I used to wrestle, we'd use a wrist lock.
Nash crapped himself again. He can't fight tonight.
Hey, Brian. Brian, you're on Runafus.
Hey, Brian.
Yeah.
You rang the cowbells already?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I know for sure that's the sound of Madonna giving birth.
Just something coming out of the void.
Why just Madonna? Not any woman. Hey, Dan, you're on Runafus.
Hey, Dan.
It's Antman. Oh, I want to know why I'm on the ban list.
I'm sorry, we can't hear you. Hello?
Hello?
Who's this?
It's Antman.
I'm sorry, hello? Something must be wrong with your phone. Could you call back, please?
Ronnie, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
I can hear you perfectly.
Oh, boy. Here we go. Right. What'd I do?
I can't hear the caller.
I know, you can't hear me, ha ha ha, laugh, what I do.
Who is that?
There's something very faint there, I'm not sure what it is.
Yeah, ha ha, laugh, what I do. Okay, spell it. Yeah, I'm gargling too. What I do?
I recognize that sound.
I can't,
No, uh-uh.
Who was that?
I have no idea. Could someone check the phone,
please?
Check
that line. I think it was line 7.
Yeah. Have Pete Johnson check the phone, something.
Here's all Pete said. Here's,
He's part of the NWO.
Here's Scott. Scottzo. What's happening?
Hey, Scottzo. What can we do for you, Scott?
Another
Ronnie,
line.
I can't hear the caller.
Is this Ass-Man? Hey, Bill. I know. Inside jokes. They work for us, nobody else.
Right now, Scott's going, what I do?
But seriously,
what
if,
I
you,
do?
If you can't get through to us, call back, please. Because mm-hmm. I want to talk to you. Bill, you're on Manifest.
Hello, Bill.
Yes, listen. That is either one of two things.
All right.
A cappuccino machine or the bong the cops took away from me in 1986.
He peaked during the Brothers in Arms album. That was the high point of his life, as well as Mark Knopfler's.
That whole money for nothing.
No, can't get enough of it.
877-692-1027.
I thought I saw Earl grabbing the rock.
Yeah, he's doing the Walk of Life.
Right here.
From the Brothers in Arms CD.
Was that on the, is that the same CD?
Or
is that just on the best of? Here you are, hitting your bong. Remember this, Earl? Scotzo loved it. Scotzo broke this. He broke every band, didn't he, Earl? Every band.
Remember when Big Earl got the walk of 20 to life?
Hey, Mike. Mike, you're on Runafest.
Hello, Mike.
Mikey Joe Fagone. We're having trouble with these phones tonight.
Did we really break the phones?
Yeah.
That's the sound of a Rottweiler.
I think he said a Rottweiler doing something. Folks, I want to explain something to everybody.
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
Do you understand what Billy's trying to say there?
It's wise, wise words for anyone to live by.
Sure.
By the way, Billy Staples, this Saturday, he's going to be at Stitches Comedy Club, Route 59, Nanuet, New York. For reservations or more information, 845-624-0851.
So he's taking the act to the stage, huh?
Yeah. So apparently it's like bring in your paycheck from the day before, and Billy will sign it for you with his own special autograph.
Wow.
Make sure you bring your paychecks to Stitches this Saturday in Nanuet.
But remember, it's all clean comedy because...
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
Never justified.
Uh-uh.
So you're not going to see his blues show.
See, if that had worked out, what he did to Alice Jack, he was going to turn that into a whole ventriloquist act that he does on stage.
No, he warned the people at Stitches. He says, now I work brown. So know that going in. You know, you're following... How'd you like to be the headliner? You're following Billy after he crapped on a paycheck.
Great to be here.
Let's bring in Billy and ask him about his gig.
All right.
Staples! Now! Smoking weed, doing coke, drinking beers, rolling baddies, smoking blunts, we smoke the blunts.
Billy, you got a big show this week?
Big show, Stitches and Nanuet, that's right.
What's happening there? What time?
That's going to be the closer this
and
week.
Just, good night, everybody. My name is Billy Staples. Tip your waitresses.
Gonna pick a lucky audience member.
Are you really gonna do this on stage?
Oh, of course.
Now you are you closing the show? You the headliner?
I believe so, yeah.
I believe so.
All right. So
now, did your new manager get you this gig, or are you going off for solo work?
Now this was a pre-existing gig.
Oh. You had this one already booked.
Oh yeah.
Before you started the new management.
No commission on this one.
Okay, yeah. So much like the Gallagher shows, so you people in the front couple of rows, the tables there, make sure you bring the big plastic and the canvas
you
to
got
cover yourself up.
I would definitely recommend it.
Mm-hmm. To cover your paycheck.
Two shows?
No, it's just one. One show. The Comfort Inn or Route 59 in Annual.
All right, you're playing the Comfort Inn.
Ah, big time, baby.
I like it.
Free continental breakfast. Is that right?
I don't know. I've never stayed over.
I put a donut in each pocket before I get the car. Yeah, I'll just take these with me.
No, it's a beautiful room, though. It's a nice club.
What makes it so beautiful?
It's big. It's pretty. And there's a bar right in the middle.
Are you drinking again?
No, of course not.
How's everything at home? Okay, Billy?
Boy, it's St. Patty's this weekend.
Couldn't be worse.
Really?
Yeah.
You want to talk about it?
Nope.
Okay. Take a break. We'll be right back. More stuff coming up. You're going to love this. You're going to love the next thing we talk about.
I am?
Matter of fact, this, Fezzy, top of the pyramid material.
All right,
coming
cool.
Coming up next on Ron and Fez.
Ron and Fez.
You're scaring me. Stop it.
1027 WNEW.
We're Ron and Fez. 877-692-1027.
Hey, coming up in a little while, Paul O is going to be doing his movie reviews this week. They're talking about the Oscars.
Oscars coming up.
Sure. Set your clocks ahead.
SAG Awards just happened.
SAG Awards.
Paul O, you like the movie?
Coming up, just a little bit of Ron and Fez. Now, Ronnie, actual big doings out of Kashmir.
No, I never expected to hear that tonight. Big doings out of Kashmir.
No, not a phrase I expected to say.
No. I never even expected to hear that phrase on the radio in New York. Big doings, ladies and gentlemen. Big doings.
Out of Kashmir. All right, now, a New York-based researcher, Suzanne Marie Olson.
I used to date her.
Really?
Yeah.
I think that was Cindy Brady's name.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Susan Olson.
Suzanne Olson. She's, I guess, an archaeologist and a researcher.
That's what I would like to tell people I am.
Now, see, that has a nice ring to it.
Ring to it. So she's an archaeologist, like Indiana Jones.
Mm-hmm, right. So she says, in Kashmir, she wants to exhume a body from a Muslim shrine there that she says the shrine is the final resting place of none other than Jesus Christ.
Oh, why not dig that up with a pickaxe? Right in here. It's the Lord and Savior.
Thank my bow, Dad.
I got his foot. All right, now, what is her name again?
Suzanne Olson.
I don't know how to explain it to you here. Suzanne. And Suzanne, you're all that I want in a girl. I think Weezer was right about that. But here's the thing, Suzanne Olson. The situation is, that body could not be Jesus Christ. He ascended into heaven.
Exactly.
As a physical being.
Mm-hmm. While his friends and disciples and family members were around him.
Literally crapping themselves.
He took off for heaven and ascended away from them.
Now, a lot of people think, oh, what, did he fly like Superman? No, he didn't do that.
No.
It's just like everything rolls up very easy.
Right,
it's not
yeah.
like you had to get a running start, leap, and just start ascending to heaven that way.
I would imagine that the clouds actually came down to meet him.
Just think of a man rising.
Right.
Like a mojo rising.
There you go.
Up out of the swamps.
So, yeah, and it's not like he, you know, Buzz Nazareth on his way back.
So, Suzanne, obviously that person that you found there is an imposter.
So she wants this body exhumed for DNA testing and carbon dating.
All right, now, first of all, and where is it, Kashmir?
Kashmir.
Where the hell is that?
Kashmir is north of India.
All right, you want to let on to me, Fez, how Jesus got over there?
I have
that would have been a haul for a man who did not have a car.
That's a problem, Suzanne Olson. So she says she thinks this is Jesus' final resting place. Now, this is the first thing she's tampered with, Ronnie.
Right.
She's already dug up a shrine in Pakistan that she said is the resting place of Jesus' mother, Mary.
All right.
Now she's just digging people up left and right.
All right, here's one of Joseph's skates. She should be under that somewhere. Okay, I hate to break this deal, and I know only Catholics believe this. Mary, Fezzy, also ascended to heaven physically.
Was taken in physical form.
Do Lutherans believe that as well?
You know, I've heard it before, but it's not something that we hear a lot of.
I noticed this. Non-Catholics, never big on Our Mary. We, and Catholics, just crazy about her.
Yeah.
Just adore her. Maybe, you know, the Protestants get weird, because we put her, all, you know, all the way like Jesus' mother, must even be better. That's the, our feelings. We're like, hey, believe me. Check with his mom.
All right, this is going to upset you then.
Yeah.
They've already exhumed the remains at the Mary tomb.
Well, how could that be, Mary? That's what I'm trying to point out.
She still had a hymen.
So now what they're saying is they want to do testing on both remains.
Yeah.
And see if there's a DNA connection. Proving what they say. Now, here's the weird thing. They want to see if the remains in Kashmir that they think is Jesus,
right,
and the remains in Pakistan that they think is Mary, if there's a DNA connection, they say, this will prove the Mary-Jesus connection. But if you're proving Mary and Jesus existed, then you can't if you have physical bodies. They've already ascended.
And do they have some other Jesus DNA that we should know about?
I know. I don't know. What in the world are they going to test against that?
Yeah, what are they comparing it with?
Did they find a cup from the Last Supper?
Yeah.
That he drank out of?
All right, come on over here. Rory wants to help us.
I know they have the Shroud of Jesus. They found that.
That one might not.
The Shroud of Turin you're talking about?
Yeah, that one I think didn't even turn out to be exactly true. Because they found out that blanket itself only went back to, like, I think 1940 is when the blanket was invented. I thought they tested that thing to see what age it was, and it wasn't the right age.
Yeah, I
thought it was.
That's
at the Vatican.
Okay. I didn't think that it went back far enough.
Yeah.
I know it got burned.
To be like, Jesus time.
It got burned in a church like probably 50 years ago.
No, it's not. It's still there. It's in the Vatican. What are you, spreading crazy rumors?
You mean that it has burn damage?
That thing
is...
Yeah,
no, it's not. It wasn't totally burned.
Oh, yeah. But they only bring that out of the Vatican like every 50 years. That's the kind of stuff that they have. They'll put it in the back and go, okay, that's it. Then we'll bring it out later. And then crowds show up. They're like Disney when they bring those movies back out.
The re-release of The Shroud.
Right. All right, Joey, you're on Manifest.
Hey,
Joey.
Guys. They're probably going for the trifecta of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph.
No, see, Joseph is the only one. I don't care whether they dig up or not.
Jesus, Mary, and Joseph.
All right, thank you very much. It's St. Patrick's Day. I think you're in no trouble if you were to dig up Joseph. But you don't go digging up Jesus or Mary, and the fact is it's neither one of them.
Right, and they always talk about, you know, if you could follow the Bible story where Jesus was crucified, Golgotha,
yeah,
and then they took his body down and they put it in a tomb there, and then that's where he resurrected from. Wouldn't that be the tomb you're looking for?
Yeah, how did he get this Kashmir? Maybe she's just a big Led Zeppelin fan and won't drop it. All right, here is Jose. Jose, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Jose.
Yeah, I just wanted to tell you that the Shroud of Turin, it hasn't been proven and it hasn't been disproven. Like
I thought they took a little piece of it and figured out how old that shroud would be, and it wasn't old enough.
No, the scientists are still split on it because they say that the shroud, it collected like I don't know what the hell it was, but it has like something in its fibers that.
All right, I'm not going to listen to you. You're not even making sense. It's Sergio, and because of this damn thing, who got us on the shroud? Rory, that's not the big story here, and you've pulled us back into and yet another shroud conversation.
You've taken us out of the framework.
Sergio, you're on Manifest.
Hey, guys. Listen, the shroud was burned during the Crusaders' time, and some scientists think that the carbon dating may not be accurate, so the dating of the shroud may be in doubt. It could go further.
All right, Sergio, let me ask you this. Do you think Jesus is over there in Kashmir?
No.
Yeah. This lady's crazy, this Suzanne.
The Suzanne Marie Olson.
I'm
going to call her by her full name. She deserves it.
Who gives her the money to do this stuff? What kind of a wacky grant is she getting?
Yeah. She's New York-based, so who's paying her checks to go around busting in on graves? Grave robber is what she is. Simple grave robber. 877-692-1027.
Matt, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, it's the Assumption of Mary, not the... Mary wasn't
Mary didn't ascend. She was assumed.
All right, how's the assumed work? How's that different from the ascend?
I don't know. I just know that's a holiday in
Because
yeah,
when
I
we
know.
Assume,
right.
What do we do?
We're making an ass
out
of who?
I think it's a P.
You... Yeah, but happened was with, you know, maybe that's just a girl way of ascending.
Could be.
But what does a...
She curtsies all the way up.
But I want to know what assume means. And
right.
What is the date? There's actually a holiday, isn't there?
The Assumption of Mary?
Yeah.
What date is that? Does anyone know?
All right, here comes Rory back.
Oh,
God. Rory, if it's
Scream
another,
Shroud and you're getting punched.
If it's a Shroud update, I'll throw in a boot at you.
I'll box your pale face.
It's August 15th is the Feast of the Assumption, which
now
was
I'm starving. What are we feasting on? Let's feast on something tonight. Let me assume we're getting food here.
I know. Why can't we ever have the Feast of March 14th?
What the hell happened with our relationship with Hard Rock Johnny? Why did that have to end?
Why is that for crap?
What does assume mean instead of ascend?
It's where God pulled her up. She didn't actually go up herself. God
oh, under
her.
Oh. Yeah, it's not under her. But to the naked eye, I'm sure it looked the same way.
Right.
Now, don't
Jesus
get me wrong.
Jesus can fly under his own power.
Right.
Jesus.
I never said Mary could fly. I didn't say she was super girl. I said she ascended. You say assume. What's the difference? I don't care. The woman rose off the planet. Well, and I believe there was music going on, there was colors.
Oh, nice.
And now you're going, hey, she's not doing that herself. That's what I'm trying to tell you. The Protestant hate for Mary, I don't understand.
So assume God comes and gets you.
Yes, right. I am assuming that.
Jesus. Ascend? I'm not saying assume, I mean assume.
Jesus ascended.
Say it the same
ascend,
way.
Ascend, you go when you're ready.
Right, you're controlling.
You're setting... It's like a hot wire. You use your flexibility with flight times.
Exactly.
But here's what I'm saying. All right, let's suppose Fez just starts ascending. Are you, Rory, going to be the first one who yells, he's just assuming. Let's not act like Fez is a big deal. What do you care? He's rising off the planet.
I know. Why is it so any less impressive?
Impressive.
All right, Patrick. Patrick, you're on Run of Fez.
Hello, Patrick.
How you doing, boys?
Okay.
Good.
My feeling is...
Oh, you have feelings now.
Fez
and I don't, but you have feelings. Okay, fine.
I'm distraught over this. All Joseph, right. The father, he got the short end of the stick on this whole story, dear.
What are you talking about? He married up.
No, he didn't.
Nobody married better than Joseph in the history of the planet.
He got the free ride of a lifetime.
No
Tom
kidding.
Tom Arnold didn't get that good a deal.
No kidding. None of Zsa-Zsa's. Husbands got such a free ride as this guy.
No, but he gave that boy
Kelly Ripa's husband.
But he gave that boy a good trade, taught him to be a carpenter, showed him how to put a nail.
I'll say this for Joseph, and it's not said enough. He raised Jesus like it was his own.
Oh, yeah.
That was the beauty of
people.
Nobody could ever say anything bad about Joseph to me.
But to say he's getting ripped off in any part of this.
No, he married up.
He's lucky to be in a family photo.
And I don't know if I've even seen him in one. No, he's not the Technicolor Dreamcoat, right?
No, that's a completely different Old Testament Joseph.
Well, then let's give that guy like Joseph B. or something. Let's not just leave the same thing. And I'm going, why would Jesus' stepfather have this beautiful pimp coat?
Who should be Joseph A. and who should be Joseph B.?
Well,
I mean, Joseph A., stepfather of God,
yeah.
Of Jesus. Joseph, with the Technicolor dream coat, actually came first chronologically.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Why such a nice coat on this guy? What was that whole deal?
He was his father's favorite.
So he wears a nice coat,
mm-hmm.
And so what? Why make a story out of him?
He was the one who got kidnapped by his own brothers and sold into slavery into Egypt.
Because they were jealous of the coat?
Yeah, they were all over a coat. That's the amazing thing. You know what they did? They took that coat. They messed it up. They killed like a lamb or something.
Mm-hmm.
Put the lamb's blood all over the coat.
Really?
And took it back to their father.
You know what I'd done if I had said? I'd have cut it into a vest.
Really?
And so I can still wear it.
Yeah. Took it back to his father and said, oh, an animal ate your favorite. But we were able to save this coat.
All right, let me just point this out. Somebody shows up here with blood on Fez's blouse. I'm still looking for Fez. I'm not going, oh, God, my partner's dead. No,
yeah.
The hunt is still on.
You're just going to assume I've...
No, I'm not assuming. I'm staying here on Earth.
No, you're going to
I don't want to assume.
You're going to presume that I'm just walking around delirious and topless.
Sure. Again. That's what
happened so many times before.
Well, Norm, when the day that you're delirious and topless, I call that Friday. All right, here's Pam. Pam, you're on the Ron Fez show.
Hey, Pam.
Hey, guys. This is my take on it.
Have a take on it now.
Right from the dictionary, assumption is a statement accepted or supposed true without proof or demonstration. So I'm thinking that Christ was supposed to have come back and walked and been recognized.
Pam, you're not getting this out of the dictionary. It's a whole different situation. It's not assumed. Fez has already pointed that out.
Uh-huh.
That's not that kind of assumption.
Right.
Like, I'm making an assumption that we are going to get food tonight. That may be a mistake. And tell Al, that's all he's going to work on.
How could it not be related? I mean, this is what the word means. That there's something going on without proof.
Keep reading to me out of the dictionary what you got there.
It also says
I'm sorry, Pam, I couldn't hear you.
Another thing about the shroud.
Yes, tell us all about it.
It's been swell, guys.
What's on?
Excuse me?
Hurt. Some people can't talk about religious matters.
No, you can't. You're absolutely right. You can't talk religion with some people.
Some people you just can't work it out with.
They assume too much.
Right. You know, Fez, in old days, in olden times, you and I would be considered wise men.
Really?
Yeah.
Magi.
You watch it.
The wise men.
Oh, I didn't know. That's what you meant. Bob, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Bob.
Is this the badass Ron Bennington and a road dog Fez Rodley?
Yes, it is.
That's Mag or Fez?
That's what we run by around here. Sure, Bob.
That's our running name, sure.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what can we do for you there, Bobby?
Listen, the assumption has to do with, are one of you guys Catholic?
Yes.
All right.
I was the lucky Catholic, and I'm going straight to heaven.
You remember that prayer, Hail Mary, Mother of God, chase the chickens out of the yard?
All right, please.
Okay, that's the assumption. The angel came down to Mary and told Mary that she was with child.
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's the assumption of Mary. The ascension of Mary is when she rose into heaven in August. I don't know if it was really in August, but that's when we
Catholics August 15th.
Documented.
All right, now...
Too bad it was in April 15th.
No, I disagree. I thought when the angel came down, I thought that was the Immaculate Conception. And
the
I try not to...
The Immaculate Conception
Don't confuse that with the Immaculate Reception.
Right.
Which was a great catch.
Which was a really, really clean wedding, right?
Mm-hmm. All right, thank you very much.
Bye.
All right, now he's saying the Assumption of Mary is when she found out she was pregnant when Gabriel, the angel, came and told her.
Yeah, that's just foolishness.
Of her...
It's foolishness.
The plans God had for.
It's just silly talk.
Reach out, touch faith.
If I was Jesus, this would be playing every time I walked into a room.
Nice.
The door would just kick open.
And you would just style and profile.
Well, first I'd have my posse coming in. I'd have my posse at 12. Ladies and gentlemen, the hardest working man. Jesus Christ, put your hands together. I would love that. All right, so anyway, we figured that out. This woman making a fool out of herself.
Suzanne Olsen.
Oh, gosh.
If that is your real name.
We are officially laughing you out of the Institute.
Ha! You and your incredible findings.
She's a fool.
She claims she found the final resting place of Jesus Christ in Kashmir, of all places.
Well, look in heaven. That's where his final resting place is.
And she's already dug up a place she said was the final resting place of Mary.
Yeah.
The Virgin Mother.
Again, she was assumed. That's what I'm assuming anyway. Here is Emily. You're on Ron and Fez.
Hi, Emily.
Hi, guys.
Hi, baby.
The Annunciation is when the angel came down.
That's what I was trying to tell the last guy.
Everyone's like all screwy on this.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
People don't.
All right.
Yeah. Now, lucky for me, Fuzzy, the best thing about being a Catholic, you don't have to know the Bible. That's why I love being a Catholic. We have people taking care of that.
Oh, nice.
And I don't understand why Protestants want to sit there and read the Bible. I don't get it. What, you know, that's like saying, who are you going to trust? Let's say you got a cavity.
Right.
Are you going to go, oh, I'll just go to a dentist who's had years of schooling and have him fix it? Or I'll get a book and start trying to drill my own tooth.
Ow.
That is what's wrong with those people. We have priests and nuns. And then we go straight to heaven.
That's nice. That's a nice arrangement.
There is nothing like being a Catholic. And by the way, the Catholic Church, now accepting Africans.
Wow.
Oh. We'll be right back. It's the Ron Fez Show.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW.
It's time for Oscar Blurbs with Paoli.
Oscar started 8. Sean Penn better not be retardy.
Rebecca Romijn will be tossing an Oscar salad.
Looks like Harry's gonna find the potter of Oscar Go.
Pluto has a big fat wife.
It is time for Oscar Blurbs with Paulo. We're out of Fez.
Hey, Paulo, your life's a movie.
Your life's a movie, how are
you? Your life's a movie, Paulo.
Paulo, your life is a movie.
Hey, your life is a big twaddle, a tattoo across your belly, Paulo.
Your life is a movie that people insist on walking out on. I don't understand.
It's a small part of my movie, the twaddle.
In the storybook career.
To me, that's the ending.
You haven't suffered any ill effects, have you, physically, since made out with Twato?
No. You could take a pound of flesh out of me, I wouldn't even notice.
And you were making out with a pound of flesh. She calls a wart.
And I'd like to point that out to Opie, who thought maybe we were doing the wrong thing by having Paulo make out with Twato. We know what we're doing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I agree.
And Paulo, you will be here walking this earth with the cockroaches and everything else long after this species of human is gone.
And I think one of the reasons why, Fezzi, he rents with Drano.
You know, it's funny.
Actually, he rents with Clorox, didn't you, Paulo?
Yeah, that's true.
Now, people ask me, did you cut that with anything?
No. Well, you know, again, let's not make a big deal out of it. There was Clorox in my mouth and there was Clorox on my face and lips. But it's not like I didn't, you know, just gargle for like a half a minute.
Right.
With it. Just quick and in and out. Just
right.
Get a brief
so
burn.
So people started, people tried to say to me, that's got to be fake. And I'm like, that wasn't even the big part of the show.
Right.
We don't care whether he rinsed his mouth out with Clorox. That's his own thing.
That was strictly the preventative measure.
Right.
The guy made out with Twato.
Yes.
There's your main event, ladies and gentlemen.
That's all selling.
That was the safety.
Now, by the way, there's new rules here at the station, too, Paulo.
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
So you now know as well.
Yeah.
All right.
Paulo, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. You've been forewarned, my friend.
Let me just stop and do something off the edge. Did we ever reach him, or are we, me and Fez, in food trouble?
What's the situation there, Ray Hamptons?
I'm going to wait, give him about, 5 to 10 minutes, and then after that we'll have another plan then.
We're going to move on.
Yeah.
We're going to move on without Hard Rock Johnny.
That wasn't him on the hotline.
No, he usually calls right back, though. So
yeah, I know. He's a good
hope.
Man. I'm going to hate to reban him, but I got to do what I got to do. You know? I'm living in my own set of rules.
We're all forced into situations
I'm living
in this
on a
life.
Prayer. Like Jesus, I'm living on a prayer.
Don't joke about fecal matter.
No, we're not, Paulo. We're talking about food. Now, Paulo.
Yes.
Ice Age is the big film this week, right?
You got Ice Age, you got Showtime, you got Resident Evil, whatever you want.
You know, first of all, at Showtime, I will watch when it gets to cable.
Okay.
And I hate to say this. Actually, it breaks my heart to say this. I'm doing that more and more with De Niro all the time.
Well, you know,
I'm waiting for cable with him.
Ronnie will only watch Showtime when it's on Showtime.
Yes, thank you.
That's his new rule.
When was the last time he did a serious movie? I can't even remember.
It's been a while. It has been a while.
I mean, yeah, it's always these jokey, Mr. King of Comedy, Robert De Niro.
Right, where's that come from? He actually was even in King of Comedy.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Good one, Paulo.
Yeah, you're funny.
The Bleach makes you funnier, I think.
I agree.
Yeah.
All right, so Ice Age is the one that's got my interest.
Okay.
All right, Ice Age, who's putting this one out?
Strangely enough, it's not Disney and it's not DreamWorks. So you combatants, it's Fox, you know, butting in the middle of the Battle of the Network Titans, or whatever the hell it is. You know, Fox is not the big player in the animation field.
No, uh-uh.
You know, it's Disney, DreamWorks, back and forth, back and forth. Now Fox, right in the middle. So this is Ice Age
from Fox Animation.
All right, all these computer animated things look alike. How is this one? How's Fox first?
It looks good. It looks good. You've got Ray Romano as the big Manfred the Mammoth. Dennis Leary is...
No, I saw that. It doesn't even look like Ray Romano.
No, the makeup is incredible in this thing.
It's that Richard Baker.
Oh, really?
You got Dennis Leary as the saber-toothed tiger. John Leguizamo as Sid the Sloth. And to me, the big star of the show is the prehistoric squirrel. And no. Jack Black plays that.
Oh, Jack. We can't see him enough. That every week, a new Jack Black is starting.
Oscar's going to be back in black, Polo.
That's good. That's good.
The strange thing is, I say, Jack Black doesn't even talk. I mean, the character, the prehistoric squirrel.
All right, so if the character Jack Black is voicing doesn't talk,
it just
does Fox go to all the trouble to hire Jack Black?
Good
you
question.
Jackass.
They could have gotten Mel Blanc Jr. for all it would have mattered. He just makes the funny squirrel noises. And that's, you know, the other characters actually talk. Ray Romano talks in the Ray Romano voice and the Dennis Leary's voice and the John Leguizamo.
So you're saying everyone loves Raymond winning an Oscar?
Yeah, I mean, it looks good, but honestly, I think they're still trying to learn from Disney because they kind of, you know, it's kind of a little bit like Dinosaur, that movie that Disney came out with.
So it doesn't match up to, like, say, a Shrek or a Monsters, Inc.?
Well, again...
Or are you saying Disney is kind of sore? That Ice Age is winning all the Oscars. Polo, why the at the end of your reviews?
That's what I don't understand.
It's some kind of...
That annoying. That's annoying me.
Right. I understand the blur because you're trying to, you know, for the first time in 40 years, get in print.
Right.
You know, but no one's going to actually write out Polo with the Ron and Fez show says
I
give it three
It's nothing I can help. As far as the Ice Age movie goes, I mean, Shrek, to me, is the...
Are you saying this film's going to kick ice at the Oscars?
Ice Age will be chilling at the, like, Bob Dylan.
Wait, a villain
at the Oscars.
Again, the guy is a medical
condition. I'm chilling like a Bob Dylan waiting on a villain at the Oscars.
Will it be a nice age for Ice Age at the Oscars?
Will Ice Age get crushed at the Oscars?
The Oscar competition is melting away for Ice Age.
Hop in your Zamboni, drive straight Ice Age, I pick up an Oscar.
I hope Ice Age doesn't get the cold shoulder at Oscar.
What was that? It sounded like Woody Woodpecker.
Yeah, what's wrong with that? It's a cartoon thing, right?
Okay, so you know, Shrek to me is the new gold standard. Or green standard.
Oh, the heck with Shrek? We're looking at Ice Age.
I don't give a Shrek.
So, I mean, you know.
You're only saying that because you're married to Shrek.
Right. How is she? Is she okay?
So, you know, for anybody who hasn't seen Shrek already.
At the end of the movie, your wife actually stays an ogre, right?
Exactly. It's kind of...
I cried.
Yes.
It was touching.
The kids laughed. I cried.
It touched me. Because it was my life, I have to agree.
Paulo, yell at your donkey. Have your wife yell at her donkey.
Who the hell are you?
That's your husband, Paulo.
Who the hell are you?
No, we're friends with Paulo.
You don't have a husband, Paulo.
Yeah, my dear wife. Yeah, she just, as I said, had the stomach surgery. Now she just, for whatever reason, she's recovering from stomach surgery, so now she has liposuction on her head.
What's she have on her head?
Liposuction on the...
Why don't you...
On her head?
Yeah, I guess around the neck, I guess, is what they do.
Why don't you just, Clorox are down.
That was a goiter they took off.
No, there's no goiter. That was my mother who had her glands removed. But the thing,
can't keep up.
I can't either. But the thing is, so, you know, so she's fine. She's going through these operations like crazy.
Some of these other people saw Ice Age.
Yeah.
Hey, Scott, you're on Run of Fez.
Hello, Scott.
Hey, what's good, fellas?
Good fellas. I get it, Fezzy. See what he said? He said, what's good, fellas?
That's
what
he meant. You like that?
I got news for you, Scott. I'm stealing it. That's beauty.
All right. Yeah, I got an Oscar blurb.
Oh, good.
The Ice Age is going to knock them out cold at the Oscars.
I like that. Hey, Craig, you're on Run of Fez.
89-14, buddies.
Hey, Craig.
Cool. J.
John is telling the Academy, let's go, me Oscar.
Hey, Blake, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, Blake.
Cardholder 11432. Thanks. Ice Age is going to warm up at the Oscars.
That's it?
Wow.
That's it, Blake?
Yeah, basically.
That's awful. Hey, Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Mike.
I'd be leery if Dennis doesn't win an Oscar.
Dennis will be all leery-eyed at the Oscars.
Mrs. O'Leary's cow just kicked over an Oscar. Polo, I hate to say it, but other people's blurbs are better than yours.
I'm sorry.
You stink, Polo.
I'm sucked.
You know, I could go to even a child, like little Lene. Little Lene.
Oh, little
Lene.
Hi, Ron. Hi, Sam.
Oh, hi, little Lene.
You'll be freezing your butt for Ice Age at the Oscars.
Oh, thank you, honey.
That's a good one.
That was good.
All right, baby.
Honey.
There you go.
Yeah. I love you.
I love you too.
Have her dad get me another water.
So.
Gig. 877-692-1027.
You know, Fred, you're on manifest.
Fred?
Do you think I can entice H. Paulo to go naked to the Oscar?
That's not gig.
You can't change it up at this point.
But do that voice anyway. Do that sound.
Fred? He hit and run.
Yeah. Hey, Anthony. Anthony, you're on Ron and Fez.
Anthony.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah.
Robin Redondo was stealing ass.
All right. That's outside the framework.
That's way outside. That was framework from about 2 hours ago.
Justin, you're on Ron and Fez.
Everybody loves Raymond's chances of winning an Oscar.
Ray will be going Romano Romano with Oscar.
Stupid sometimes.
Ray Romano will be taking it one day at a time until the Oscars.
That's not his move. That's not his show.
Oh, I'm thinking of Ann Romano.
Yes.
Ann Romano.
Who's great. And I haven't seen her in 20 years.
Damn. I'm stupid.
And they have a lot of supporting voices in this.
Let me just say this for Ann Romano. My favorite part of that show, One Day at a Time, is that she would look in the mirror at one point of every show and go, I'm scared and I don't know what to do. Every show. I don't know what to do.
You're absolutely right. Here's what you do. Go back to that husband of yours. Right. He made a fine living. He took care of you and those two girls.
And
do the right thing. Go back to that husband.
And get a bolt on that door so this guy can't come walking in when you got daughters walking around in their little panties.
That's what he's hoping for.
Well, the Oscars are coming up, finally.
Absolutely.
But the SAG Awards, any surprises there? Anything that shocked you?
You know, okay, first of all, let me say that this Russell Crowe, I've been following his career since he's been following
Russell Crowe. Wow, you're
the stalker from last year's Oscar ceremony. They were so worried about.
He's given a lot of great performances before anybody knew who he was when he did the L.A. Confidential. Now he's just become a giant moron. And I mean, be honest with you, if I ever was in the same room with him, I just like to poke him in the chest all after. I mean, just.
You think he'll take it from you, or you think it'll be go time?
No,
do you mean with your pud?
This guy has turned into a nut.
Now, let me ask you this. What kind of circles do you run into that you could end up in a room with Russell Crowe?
I'm not saying.
Because you hang with homeless people.
Right.
I'm just saying.
If your wife's ever up for a SAG award, you'll find yourself in the audience.
Now, your wife, Polo.
Yeah.
She didn't win the SAG award?
No.
But she did win the HAG Award.
How did that walk out?
That's
now,
nice.
Mrs. Polo, she didn't win the SAG Award. Picked up an old NAG Award.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Now, and again, Halle Berry.
Now, Mrs. Polo didn't win the SAG Award, but she did win the She's on the Rag Award.
Again.
Nice.
Actually, it's
body.
Now, she didn't win a SAG award, but her breast always SAG award came her way.
Oh, okay.
She actually has very large
breasts. She didn't win the SAG award, but she did win the When I Look at Her, She Makes Me Want to Gag award.
Yeah. No, she did not win a SAG award, Fezzy, but she looks like Ed Asner in Drag Award.
Oh, yeah, she did pick that up. Now, she didn't win the SAG award, Ronnie.
Yeah.
But she did pick up the She Can Eat 20 Pork Chops Not to Brag award.
Now, she did not win a SAG award, Fez.
Mm-hmm.
But her favorite purse is a grocery bag award.
Oh, okay. Now, I know she didn't win the SAG award.
That's right.
But she did pick up the She Married a Jag Off award.
Oh, I see. That'd be Polo.
Right, yeah.
Now, Mrs. Polo did not win the SAG award.
True.
But when she's happy, Watch Your Tail Wag award.
Oh, she picked that one up.
Yeah.
All right. Now, she didn't pick up the SAG award.
She didn't get that?
No, she didn't get the SAG award.
Right. Yeah.
But she did pick up the Is That Her Ass or a Giant Saddlebag award. That was one of the things.
Now, she didn't win a SAG award.
Right.
But she did win the She's As Big As a Country and Ought to Have Her Own Flag award.
Oh, good for her.
That came her way.
That's good. Now, I know with Mrs. Polo, she didn't win the SAG award. That's definitely. That went to Halle Berry. But she did pick up the Wasn't She on the Cover of Nude Sasquatch Porno Mag award?
I saw that. That was her.
That was her. So that was her trophy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, she didn't win a SAG award.
Uh-huh.
But she did win. In the wild, scientists like to track her with an ear tag award.
Oh, okay. Nice. Good for her. Now, she didn't get the SAG award, Mrs. Polo. No SAG award. But she did get the She's So Fat, If You Tried to Cross Her, You'd Get Jet Lag award.
Now, she didn't get the SAG award, Mrs. Polo.
No.
But she did win the She's So Ugly, She Could Turn Ron Jeremy into a Fag award.
Interesting. Good for her.
I question him anyway.
Now, she didn't get the SAG award.
Yeah.
But she did pick up the She Couldn't Walk Through the Lincoln Tunnel Without Her Dress Getting a Snag award. She's that wide.
She's that big.
Yeah.
No, she didn't get the SAG award, Fez.
Yeah.
But she did get the, oh my God, I think she ate Fanny Flagg award.
Oh, good for her.
Who knows Fanny Flagg at this point?
Everybody that really enjoyed Candy Camera. They're still on reruns. Your only problem with that
and anyone who picks up the book Fried Green Tomatoes.
She's wonderful. She wrote that herself.
She was in Five Easy Pieces as well.
Really?
Yeah.
Your wife's all five by herself.
So,
one big easy pizza.
She was in Five Easy Pizzas.
No. Anyway, the Oscars are coming up.
Can we talk to her?
No. As I told you, she has liposuction. Like, she just has, she has like a giant bandage.
Where is she right now?
She's actually at the other apartment. She has a giant bandage.
How many apartments you got there, Polo?
Well, we have the house for the old for Marie, and then the apartment that.
So you're alone tonight.
Well, no, I have my mother. She just went to bed.
You are drowning in real estate. For a guy who's got nothing going for him, you are picking up houses as people drop dead left and right.
But every one of them smells like an old lady.
Well, actually, they're just dragging us down. All
Polo, let's get you back up here, okay?
Polo?
Can't we wait till everybody dies? I mean, at least.
You belong in Dykeman.
Bring
the dike to Dykeman.
Look,
bring the dike back to Dykeman.
Let's face it, this is a great country, but New York City is the greatest city in the world. Or is that Miami Beach, whatever.
You're an idiot.
Or is that Miami Beach?
Every time you speak, you help the terrorists.
The terrorists win when you talk. It's what the president told us.
So, but I never get this. We're supposed to go see Ice Age?
I
have no idea.
How many cubes do you give that?
I would say it's like...
What about your wife, the mammoth? What does she say?
I'm saying that the comedy, except for the crazy prehistoric squirrel...
What about the other movie, the one with De Niro? Should we go see that?
Again.
What's that called, HBO?
The thing there is
Showtime.
I got to make
Showtime. I thought it was the Magic Johnson story. Showtime.
The sequel's Primetime. They're going to get Dion.
No, they're going to be showing Showtime at the Apollo, because I'll go.
No, it's Showtime with Polo.
Well, you know, you've got Eddie
Showtime
Murphy, and you've got
with
De Niro's daughter. De Niro's daughter, Drina De Niro, is in the film. He has a big part.
Any white people in this show at all?
Well, De Niro's white.
Technically, sure.
So, I mean... William Shatner, to me, is the big standout here. If we got more Shatner in this film, it would have been better.
Now, does he drown anyone in this one?
No, actually, no. He plays himself.
So he's breaking it up a little bit.
Yeah.
Good for him. Nice.
Yeah, he's good. And Resident Evil is actually probably the most enjoyable, the most fun.
Who's in that? What's happening there?
Mila Jovovich and Michelle Rodriguez. It's not the point who's in it. It's that.
I don't even like movies with people in them. I like launcher.
I would like more movies with just plants. That'd be nice.
It's from that enjoyable video game, the Resident Evil. And, you know, there was lots of fun-filled hours spent
Speaking of mutant dogs, how's your wife?
It's fine. You got flesh-eating zombies. It's been very enjoyable.
Speaking of flesh-eating zombies, how's the wife? You doing okay? How is she?
It has nothing to do. My wife is not a flesh-eating zombie or a mutant dog.
She's sick, right?
But there are...
If the serial killer in Hannibal Lecter in Silence of the Lambs got a hold of her, he could make a whole girl wardrobe,
honestly,
a girl suit.
She's trying to straighten her life out as best as can be said. I mean, I think she's doing, some good positive things. She's doing yoga.
She's yoga.
They inflate that liver anymore. It could cover games at Yankee Stadium
a
blimp.
I know. Believe me.
Paulo, I wish we had all night to do this. We got to move on, okay?
I understand.
Someday, I'd like you to talk about movies when you call.
That'd be too much to ask?
Can you do that one day?
It's not a problem for me. I understand.
It seems like it.
It's not my problem. I'm trying to talk about movies.
All right. Next week's going to be your Oscar picks, right?
Okay.
I can't wait.
Absolutely.
It'll be if we pick the Oscars.
Do we do predictions or what we'd like?
You know what? I need to think of the exact opposite to tell you because that's what you're going to do.
Oh, wait a minute. Are we going to have him on? Because guess who's doing our show next week, Fez? Harry Knowles, who Paulo should have been.
Yes. That's true.
That's because he's more ambitious than me, you know.
You should be the big guy that the movie studios fear.
I'll get in a wrestling match with him, and we'll see where it goes.
You're the guy that your neighbors fear.
I understand.
And Russell Crowe, we found out.
Yeah, well, let me get me in a room with him. Kick his ass.
You're constantly wanting to fight people.
No, I don't like big shot bullies like that. He was good when he was just an actor, but now he's Mr. Ego.
All right, let's not turn this into something personal, okay?
So we've been
doing a classy show all night.
So on your Hollywood list, Paulo,
yeah,
it's Russell Crowe that needs a good slap across the face.
I like to bitch slap him. So bad.
All right, if you had the opportunity right now, Fez, if God let you bitch slap whoever you want.
Uh-huh.
You know what? We'll come back to this.
Let me think.
But during the commercial break, everyone think, if you could bitch slap one person and get away with it,
right across the chops.
Just paintbrush them.
Yeah.
Who would it be?
Okay.
We only get one each.
Oh, man. All right, so for Paulo, it's Russell Crowe.
Sure.
Right now.
The great two-time Academy Award winner.
All right, we'll be right back with our bitch slap. We get one bitch slap.
Nice.
It's Ron and Fez.
Ron and Fez. Frequency. 1027 WNEW.
The Ron and Fez Show presents Everything I Need to Know I Learned in Bayonne, New Jersey by Joe Poe. I learned that if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. Unless there's a fat F walking a small dog, then he's just asking for it. For Everything I Need to Know I Learned in Bayonne, New Jersey, I'm Joe Poe.
We're Ron and Fez, 877-692-1027 is our toll-free phone number.
We got into this who-would-you-bitch-slap situation, Fez. How about you?
All right, I debated this during the commercial break. I actually went through, three different people. I'm going to go with Mr. Jay Leno.
Really?
What I think would be my bitch-slapper.
Now, are you bitch-slapping him for a reason or to wake his ass up?
Wake his ass up, basically. You're unfunny F. What are you doing on The Tonight Show? And I know it's been 10 years. And I should have bitch slapped him earlier.
Yeah, you should have got to him earlier.
But he's just hideous.
You don't like Jay?
He's just absolutely the worst. I tried to watch it the other night. I got home in time. And it is unwatchable. What he's done to that show is unforgivable.
Turn on Dave. It's always enjoyable. Now, here's the weird thing. More people watch Jay.
Yeah.
Shock to me.
That drives me nuts.
What the F is wrong with humans?
I don't understand.
the appeal.
All right, Paul, you're on Manifest.
Hey, how's it going, boys?
Hello, yeah. Paul.
If I could bitch slap anyone, it would definitely be Joan Rivers. I can't stand her.
Oh, you got your whole Joan Rivers season coming up here with all the award shows.
Oh,
I
yeah.
can't take her.
She's going to be everywhere, Paul.
Like a retarded child.
You would bitch slap a retarded child.
How about you, Joe Poo?
Daryl Strawberry.
Why?
Because I'm sick of seeing him in the paper effing up once a week.
Guy's got a problem. He literally has a problem.
He's he
a
had sick. All those chances he's in baseball, sick. And now he's in the paper again. I'm tired of
he's a
of
sick
him.
Human being.
If we
sometimes
start...
he likes to have sex with the other sick people. What's wrong with that?
If we start bitch-slapping people every time they F up, you'd be going home black and blue constantly.
That's true. Talk about effing up your shot. You did it. You know what? Every day, you know what to say? Thank you for my job, Fez. You protected me from Ron. And in the meantime, guess who owes me? Fez. Not you. Isn't that the odd thing how life works?
It's odd.
Fez owes me.
The circle of life.
Hey, Don, you're on Ron of Fez.
Hey, Don.
Hey, big card holder, 12351.
It's big ass.
Hoo-ah!
It's just a big card. It's a big ass card.
The card is normal size.
Look how sad he looks now.
He's very upset.
You're a sad boy. What is it, Don?
I want to bitch slap the guy from the Dell commercial.
Really? Steven?
Dude, you're getting a Dell!
You're wasting your one bitch slap. But just say, you know, remember, you get one and that's it.
You know, I bitch slap now, Fezzy, and I thought this over.
Yeah?
Blaine Ensley.
Really?
One last time. Give him one to remember me by. So scared? I'll give you one more on your way out the door.
Blaine Ensley, of course, released here for going into Opie's locker. Yeah. Stealing a batting glove.
Well, he's got a new job. Because Rocky loves Blaine Ensley. Rocky loves Blaine Ensley. Rob, you're on Run the Fez.
Hello, Rob.
What's up, guys? What's up, guys? 2630 checking in. I would bitch slap Rosie O'Donnell.
Why?
Because, well, she has to come out and tell everyone she's a dyke. We knew that already. That's stupid. You're wasting my time.
She's keeping it.
You're wasting my time.
I need someone who I didn't know was a dyke to come out for me. Hey, Ralph. Ralph, you're on Run-A-Fez.
Hello, Ralph.
How you doing, gentlemen?
Yeah.
If I could bitch slap anybody, I'd bitch slap Don Geronimo.
Why Donnie?
Where's that come from?
Because he just buries the other guy. The other guy's a real talent. You know that. Michael.
I heard Don carries him. I've heard from the bosses here, Don carries him.
Well, look at your situation. Fez is the real talent on that show.
Yeah. So you're saying there should only be one person on each show?
No. I mean,
that's rough.
The passive one.
Why not bitch slap me?
No.
Oh, so you only like passive people?
No, I always vote for the weaker guy. I'm a Mets fan.
Wait a minute.
Well, let's be honest, Fez.
What? How did this compliment go so awry?
First of all, he takes a shot at Don, and now he's calling you and Mike the weaker sex.
Where's that come from, Ralph?
I mean, let's be honest, Fez. You are the underdog in the show. I mean, Joe Poole is starting to overshadow you, which is scaring the hell out of me. A guy from Bayonne.
All right.
Do you want to slap Joe then?
No.
All right.
You never hit anybody from New Jersey.
That's true. 877-692-1027.
Hey, I got an email from Frank here, and there's some feedback. Frank says, David Letterman sucks. His show, totally not funny. Top 10 list about the dumbest, unfunny thing on TV. People who like his show are just bandwagon jumpers. It's not like it's a new show.
How mindless, are you jumping on a bandwagon of something that's not winning?
Mindless sheep who wouldn't know a good joke if it crapped on their paycheck. Frankie, come on.
You're right. It's no Iron J. You're absolutely right.
Hey, Lauren, you're on Run of Fizz.
Hello, Lauren. Lauren?
Hey,
yeah,
hi.
Go ahead.
Hi, how are you? I'm nervous.
I can bitch slap anyone.
Yeah.
It would definitely be Whitney Houston.
Are you calling from your walk?
I'm in the pool, guys.
Do you work in a well?
What pool are you in?
The one in the private building that I work in. The whole health club pool thing.
That sounds great.
No, you guys get me through the day.
Well, thank you, baby.
That's nice.
Oh, God.
Yeah. I wish I was there with you.
I would definitely bitch slap Whitney Houston, though.
Why? Oh, Fez, she fell in.
Oh, no.
Lauren! Lauren!
Throw her a rope.
I guess she fell in twice.
She fell in, fell back out, and in again.
Wow.
Oh, that laugh is too scary with the echo.
You know what, Fez, you know what I want to do? I want to play a show in a pool and just kill in that place. You only get three laughs, it just is reverberating.
Oh, man.
All right, thanks a lot.
Bye.
Hey, Adam. Adam, who would you bitch slap if you had the chance? Hey, Adam.
Hey, what's up, guys? Yeah. If I could bitch slap anybody, it would be Mini-Me.
Oh, you take his little head off.
Vern Troyer.
Yeah, Vern Troyer. He thinks he's so cool.
Yeah, what makes him so cool?
He's got his little cocktail weenie fingers, and he's getting all the chicks. It's garbage.
Hey, show people are just the same as you and me. Don't want no show people. Poor Mini-Me. You think you'd kill Mini-Me if you bitch slapped him first?
Yeah, I don't think he's in that great of health to begin with.
No.
The little people never are.
No, they don't live long, do they?
Mm-mm.
They don't live long.
Except for Billy Barty. He seemed to go on forever.
Now, also, Billy Barty died, Fezzy, last year?
Yeah.
He was 30.
Really?
30.
Oh, my God. I take it all
now,
back.
Short people don't live long. Neither do tall people.
No, uh-uh.
You'll never see an old seven-footer.
Uh-uh. You got to have a comfortable medium there.
Right. You actually don't want to be over 6 foot to enjoy a long life.
Yeah.
You won't run into an old six-footer.
It's not going to happen. Their hearts can't take carrying that body around for
long. You want to be in the 5'7", the 5'9" range.
Perfect. Absolutely perfect.
Fez, I'm sorry if you're coming off as the weaker sex or the Mike O'Mara of the show. I never meant to do that. You know that, right?
Well, I'm with you.
I just talk faster. That's all.
I get on.
Yeah, you're on, Rob. What's the big deal?
Hey, Ron says, what's going on, guys? Hey,
what can we do for you, Rob?
Listen, my girl and I were just sitting back, blowing a ball in the air, and we're flicking through the channels. And what do I see? Yeah. I come across the rosy, behind-the-scenes O'Donnell.
Spy report.
Yeah. Oh, my Lord.
Are you enjoying it?
What's that?
Are you enjoying it?
Am I enjoying it? I don't know what to expect over here. I'm watching this girl try to fight for gay guys' rights to have children. Now, listen, no disrespect. Yes, no disrespect. I know you're a little on the heavenly side, you know, but I love you, dude.
What?
Yeah,
gay people in a lot of states can adopt children, and what's wrong with that?
Yeah, but it's dude, the come on time. Television now, like, what are you doing? You know what I mean?
Are you upset with the gay guys or with Rosie?
I'm upset with Rosie, like, you know. I got no beef with any gay guys at all. As a matter of fact, I have a couple friends that are gay, and they're really
cool. I bet you do.
I really do, believe it or not. But this chick here, she's really, like, not right. You know what I mean?
I tell you what, Rosie is going through so much stress. I watched a little bit of it today because she had the lovely Kelly Ripa on.
Right, yeah.
During the interview, I look over, Rosie's popping snacks in her mouth. When have you, and it wasn't like part of a bit or doing anything, she is just eating snacks while she's doing an interview.
She asked Kelly Ripa about daytime Emmy nominations.
Yeah.
Realizes, okay, she's got to answer me for a while here.
Yeah.
And you see her.
You saw the same thing?
Yeah. I absolutely. She kind of leaned around behind her desk, popped a treat in her mouth, a Scooby snack.
Now, you can do that in radio. But on TV, you should be like on the Food Network. Yeah, then you can pop some food in.
So then the next question you hear, the candy in her mouth.
So Regis is nice.
And your husband got nominated too? Unbelievable.
Has that Kelly Ripa just getting cuter and cuter every day?
Kelly Ripa's adorable.
Yeah.
And then, of course, Rosie finishes out. As if she hasn't had enough snacks at the desk, she brings the crazy woman out for a cooking segment of a cake where it's really just a bunch of snack cakes piled on top of each other, held together with Cool Whip.
What the hell's Mikey Day? I'm starving. I'm very nervous. Mikey D is filling in as a intern for the next couple of days, which is so beneath him, as after his show business background.
5-time Tony Award nominee.
And he's interning for us.
Mm.
But this is his first time making a food run, and that's something I don't like people effing around with. It's like effing with my emotions when you're doing that.
He should have stayed to count the Tic Tacs. and let Al, who knows
the
path of the food runs, the, you know, the way it's supposed to be done, get where everything's at.
Get big gay cricket in here, would you?
You can't come popping in here as gay as a cricket.
Please don't. Al, why would you let Mikey D make this run on his own first night?
A rookie.
Because he knows the neighborhood, and I told him where it was.
Still, it's my food.
I'm confident.
I'm a nervous wreck. You're confident.
It's going to come back great.
You couldn't have run to get the food?
You tried to get me to buy a $16 hamburger. Instead, I'm paying $20 for an egg sandwich. But see, the point is, I know it's cheaper.
The money he wanted for my chicken strips, I should have been wearing them as earrings. Ow.
Get away.
Just it'll become, away. It'll come
you're,
back
you're
perfect.
Sucking, you know what? We're in the middle of another, what I consider the third hour of a best-of show, and you're sucking the oxygen out.
You know, you're anti-framework.
You're like a cat that jumped in the comedy crib and sucked the oxygen out of a comedy baby. A joke baby.
Because the cat will do that. That's a true fact. Why don't you wait downstairs, or better yet, go look for Mikey D.
Yeah.
On the streets of Manhattan.
Okay. Dress like a woman and chase him.
877-692-1027.
Hey, Justin, who would you bitch slap if you had the opportunity? Anybody at all?
Hey, what's up, buddies?
Hey, buddy.
Without a doubt, Billy Staples.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, who wouldn't?
Yeah, but this is what you'll hear.
You know what, though?
This is how hungry I am.
It's worth it.
I can hear it.
You think you could bitch him? Bitch slap him?
Absolutely.
Because I tell you, with Billy, he hits back, as Paranoid knows.
I was there at the first Big Ass Niners fights, and he's nothing.
All right, thank you very much, my friend. Now, next Big Ass Night of Fights, he has said that he is taking on Dan from Hoboken. Opie, the other day, said to me, Fezzy,
right?
Is Dan crazy? Nobody can beat Billy. I'm like, you saw him in one fight, Opie.
Billy Staples, who, let's face it, destroyed Paranoid,
mm-hmm.
and then danced an Irish jig.
Now, does that just make Billy look like he's a great fighter because he crushed a guy who wasn't really ready for him?
I think what happened was everyone was surprised that Billy had enough wind.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
To go, you know, to do the things he did in the ring.
Hey, Rory, I saw that Paranoid sent us a song. Did you have a chance to listen to it?
No, I haven't looked at it yet.
Yeah, okay.
I'll get it.
All right. That's all right. Just as long as you know. As long as you know that I know. That's what I want you to know. You don't have to go running out here now. He's got all day. He's got all day to listen to a song.
Fender.
Well, I think he's burnt out. I think the kid needs a rest. Every other show takes a week off.
I am.
The Ron and Fez show keeps going and going and going. Like the Energizer Bunny.
Like nut bars.
Yeah. And no matter what we do, Fezzy, Alan Sniffin's never going to love us.
No.
We'll never get a Sniffy Award.
Uh-uh. We'll never get the Sniffy.
We're sniffing for some love.
877-692-1027.
19 posts love us, 2 hate us, and written by the guy who owns the board.
Uh-huh.
Now what are you going to do?
The guy who gives out the Sniffies.
Yeah.
I'd love to catch the Sniffies from him once.
He's sniffing nitrix. Hey, Mark, you're on Run
a
Fist.
Hey, Mark.
Hey, guys. Yeah. How you doing?
Yeah.
If I had one person to bitch slap, it would have to be John Gotti now.
I don't want
to
even hear that.
We
that
won't participate in that, my friend.
It seems like there's something wrong with the phone. I couldn't understand what he was saying.
I didn't even hear the name you mentioned.
Well,
I think he said Gotti.
Really?
I hope not, though.
Hey,
act like you didn't hear him. Just act like you didn't hear him.
I'm going to act like I didn't hear you. And that way I'm just taking care of
it. That way you're completely in the clear.
Hey, Nikki. Nikki, you were on the Ron and Fez show.
How you doing, Ron? What's up, Fez?
Hey, Nikki.
You know, I'd love to
do it. Hey, Nikki, you're so fine. You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Nikki.
Nah, it's Mickey, man. It's
hey,
Nikki. Like Nikki.
Oh, I always thought that song was Kinnicky.
Yeah, if I had to, I'd do us all a favor and bitch slap Tom Brokaw, maybe knock his speech impediment out of his head.
You don't like Tom Brokaw?
I don't like his speech impediment.
Out of all the people in the world, you want to slap Tom Brokaw?
I know you get one.
I hate NBC Nightly News.
Really?
Yep.
What do you watch?
Did they do a bad report on you once or something?
Yeah, they uncovered my secret.
Are you part of the fleecing of America?
Yeah, I'm the fleecing of America.
All right, Nikki.
Thanks, guys.
Okay, Nikki.
I think people are wasting their one and only bitch slaps.
I got to agree with you there. Hey, Eddie. Eddie, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Eddie.
Jay Cardola,
10330.
If I was going to bitch slap one person, it would be Mayor Giuliani.
Mayor Giuliani, the man's a hero.
America's mayor.
Yeah, and
the world's mayor. Fezzy, the world's mayor.
Wow. I missed that election.
No, but he went over to Europe. They made him a knight. A knight of the round table.
So you're going to bitch slap Sir Rudy?
Oh, absolutely. All the guys that he brought on the shoulders of, the guys who were doing all the work at the World Trade Center.
No, Rudy did all that work.
Oh, he did all the work by himself?
Yes. Rudy was down there digging. He was doing stuff. He did it all. He never slept.
He gave himself a $35,000 raise.
That's peanuts.
He cops and firemen zeros.
You're talking about a person that we believe now is a saint, Rudy Giuliani. A man who actually, when you think about it, was the one who put out the fires.
Right.
And then also patrolled the streets, like Batman.
And the whole time nestled this city to his bosom.
Hey, Roy. Roy, you're on manifest.
Roy. Roy.
Buddy.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, 7510.
That's a fine card number.
All right, if I wanted to smack one person.
No, bitch slap.
All right, bitch slap one person. It had to be Scott Farrell. Because that guy has the most annoying voice.
Can I tell you something? Right now, Scott Farrell is the man of the morning, they're calling him. Not man of La Mancha, man of the morning.
How can you stand that voice, though? Seriously.
I don't get off that early. I'm just telling you what I've been hearing from people.
Oh, the street buzz.
The street buzz.
Right.
It's unbelievable, Fez. It's a street. It's more than a street buzz. It's a street buzz Burbank.
Yeah, W.
Wow, that is bigger.
What did he yell at? He tried to yell his .com. I would have given it out.
Yeah, you don't have to .com and run.
Yeah,
yeah. The word is
Radio Insider. Radio Insider. Spy Report. Radio Insider.
Pharrell, the next big thing.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Who was the last big thing?
Who would be the last big thing?
Can we be a big thing someday?
Huh. I don't know who he had the last big thing. I'm not sure who that would be.
I thought it was, what's his name from Fox, O'Reilly, now doing radio.
Oh, yeah.
There's,
Radio Insider.
I don't want to break a Radio Insider thing.
Radio Insider.
My prediction, Bill O'Reilly will sign with Westwood One.
Radio Insider. Radio Insider.
There you go. Write it down.
Write it down, folks. You heard it here last.
Actually, write down the words Radio Insider, Spy Report, then, you know, in quotes, what Ronnie said, and then write Ron Bennington below that.
Yeah.
So they have it all.
Now, here's also another.
Radio Insider.
Rush Limbaugh seems to have trouble with his hearing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Radio Insider.
Everybody at Rush heard that here first.
Yeah. Here's another.
Radio Insider.
I think Howard's marriage is not working out.
Really?
Look for him to head to Divorce Street. You heard it all on
Radio Insider.
Right here on Ron and Fez.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Radio Insider.
Imus isn't getting any younger.
No.
Radio Insider.
There you have it. I broke the story myself, Fezzy.
There you go. You got it. Right here. Your source.
Radio Insider.
Your news source.
Mm-hmm. Here's a...
Radio Insider.
A little something picked up on the buzz, on the street buzz.
Oh, yeah?
Look for Opie and Anthony to be taking a week off.
Radio Insider.
Nice.
Okay.
All right.
All right. You heard it here first.
All right.
Listen Monday for a best of because...
Radio Insider.
They'll be on the beach for a week, my friends. You heard that on Radio Insider.
Hope you got a chance to jot all of it down.
Radio Insider.
Here's another Radio Insider for it. AM radio, not very good for the music station. So not going to get a nice sound there.
Right.
Radio Insider.
All right, that's not radio. Not a lot of people are going to pull the curtain back, let you look backstage here. Fez and I will.
We don't mind.
Radio Insider.
That's the way it works here.
That's the game we play.
We include you.
Yeah. We won't talk about ourselves.
No.
But we'll talk about other shows. Mm-hmm. All on
Radio Insider. Spy Report. Spy Report.
You're listening to the Ron and Fez show.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW.
Joe Pooh, tell us all about Sam Adams.
Sam Adams. The college basketball tournament kicked off today. Basketball. A great American pastime. And Sam Adams. A great American beer. They go hand in hand. There's no better way to celebrate your favorite team's victory than with America's best tasting beer, Sam Adams. I love Sam Adams. As a matter of fact, I'm going out tonight with a couple friends. We're going to go down to the local bar and pop back a few Sam Adams. Sam Adams has a smooth, crisp, flowing taste that just rolls down your tongue into your stomach. I was an art major, and you're glad that you drank the Sam. It's the best-selling beer. Me and my friends drink Sam Adams. Everybody at Ron and Fez drinks Sam Adams. We're going to drink it before the show, during the show, and after the show. Sam Adams. It's a very good beer. Very good beer. All the time. Right now, I'm drinking a Sam Adams. Maybe two of them if this goes a little bit longer. Maybe even three. Because, you know what? Sam Adams is delicious. I love the Sam Adams. Earl Douglas drinks the Sam Adams. Rory, my best bud, also drinks Sam Adams. Everyone here drinks Sam Adams because we're buds and we love beer. So grab some Sam Adams for your big game party and get the party going. Be a better beer drinker. Drink a better beer. Sam Adams, it's America's world-class beer.
Ron and Fez, 1027 WMZ.
Up on the reef. When this old world starts getting you down, then people join us in this restful place.
Up on the reef.
Just lay right back, get out of the rat race, and all your cares just drift right into space. As can be, 'cause everyone loves Ron and loves Fezzy. No more yelling now, so when you tune in at 7 each night, you'll go to a place where the sharks don't bite. A place so nice, it's beyond belief. Starts 1 hour past the 6 o'clock.
On the reef, we're running
Fez. Fez, that's going to be the song of the summer of '02. When people can't take it anymore at nights, they'll just get up on Tar Beach, up on their roof, and listen to the Ron and Fez show.
And then years from now, lovers will think back of their first summer together and the song that was playing
with their lovers.
Oh, and how it had such a cold ending. Remember that.
Yeah, we always want to have a nice...
And they'll think back and say, what a nice song. Why didn't it fade out?
A lot of people writing a lot of nice things about Joe Poo doing live reads.
Really?
Yeah.
Jim Cook, not one of them.
No. Jim Cook says, do me a favor, when you're talking about my brand, don't call someone your bud. We're all buds. My best bud is Rory.
So, get your buds.
I thought your best bud was Ray Ray.
He's in Florida. He's not my friend.
Wonder Boy. We've got him on the phone, Fezzy.
All right.
Wonder Boy.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
How's Florida? How's spring break?
We just got here.
Yeah.
So we haven't really gotten to do anything yet. We just got to our room.
Uh-huh.
But
oh, nice.
One room, huh?
Well, no. I got to my room. Rachel's in a different room.
And then you got a nice place?
Yeah, actually, it's really nice.
Where are you staying? The Marriott?
Yeah, Marriott Bay. It's like a whole little village kind of here.
Uh-huh.
And, which is good because it seems to be pretty set apart from everything else. But it's a nice place, and they have, like, promotional stuff for the movie. Like in the lobby where you check in and stuff. So it's cool.
Like, what kind of freebies have you gotten?
I don't know, actually. I got a bag. I didn't look through it yet.
Let's do it now. Let's look through your bag.
I was just trying to unpack my stuff. Let's see. Of course, suntan lotion, a little a Hawaiian tropic bottle where, like, it's a spray bottle with a fan?
That's suntan lotion. You better have a 95 block.
Irish boy.
I tried to get a suntan sweater, but they wouldn't give it out. Also, matches from the movie and another
What
bottle.
Movie think matches is going to help? That helps out a tap room.
Something that you can't use while watching the film in a crowded theater.
Oh, you know what? Actually, I'm going to rescind that statement. I didn't open the matchbook. It's actually something else. It says,
it's a condom, isn't it?
Wrap your tool, yeah.
What is
a picture of the guy from the movie on it.
What's the saying?
Don't be a fool, wrap your tool.
Okay.
So.
Thank you.
He's still trying to light a cigarette with it.
Isn't it just as easy to squirt on her chest?
Just as far as I'm concerned, it's a lot
just
easier.
Just as safe. Good news about Wonder Boy. Our first intern, Fezzi, who actually went and got a gig here at WNEW, he starts Monday.
That has never happened in the history of our program here.
And I knew it, Wonder Boy. I knew the day I met you.
Thanks.
Hey, how's Tenacious C taking that, though?
Oh, she's taking that I have a job?
Yeah.
She's very happy that I have a job.
From the instant feedback, Friday Fright is out on the roof.
Yeah. Friday Fright and Putting Together. They're jumping. They're holding their hands and jumping.
The Thelma and Louise of interns.
All right, listen, I got to finish getting ready as much as I'd love to talk. All the movie stars are staying here.
Sorry to bother you, asswipe.
No.
We send you on a thing, and you're saying us, I got to blow you off.
No, I just wanted to have something more to talk to you about than the hotel room.
Hey, Tenacious C.
Hello.
Hi, baby.
Hi, Tenacious.
Hello.
Rachel, I can't tell you how much I miss you.
I know.
I haven't gotten wood since I've been here.
It's just not the same without you.
As long as I stare at Earl, nothing happens for me.
Oh, you guys are too sweet.
And he's really trying, too.
You're too sweet. You're too sweet to say you get Earl. See, how was your flight today?
Oh, it was nice.
Yeah?
The second plane was a little small.
Really?
A little worried.
Did you have to dust some orange crops first before you landed?
Yeah, we did some circles.
They were pulling a banner, Fez. Straight up the beach. All right, so where are you guys off to tonight? A party?
Yeah, it's the National Lampoon's party.
Oh, maybe the late Doug Kenny will be there. Maybe Belushi will come in.
Let's hope not. What time's your party?
I think they're coming back around 9:30.
Okay.
Oh, they're picking you up there?
Yeah.
All right, now you guys an hour behind us?
Uh-huh. Actually, we are.
Oh, you hit that central time zone.
Yeah.
Forbidden zone in Florida.
Oh, great. Well, here's the weird thing. Don't think that the shows come on later, because they don't. They just come on earlier. It's a very weird deal. At least on the West Coast, things feel normal. Well, I'm glad you guys are having fun, and you've gotten us a lot of stuff for the show. It's really working out.
Yeah, it is completely worth our time and effort to send you. What's the plan for tomorrow?
We have to. We get to interview the stars of the movie and the director. We're going to do that at 10.
When are you going to start working on your most important project?
Well, tonight, actually. As soon as we get going over to the club that we're going to.
All right, Wonder Boy, what room are you staying in?
2232.
2232. And what's the place?
The Marriott Bay.
Marriott Bay. What's the phone number there?
It's not on the phone here. As soon as I get it, I can call you back with it.
They always have a notepad right next to the phone, or it's usually written on the phone.
Oh, indeed. All right, you can call toll-free at 800-228-9290.
Is that for reservations or the actual hotel?
That's for a vacation brochure. Hang on.
You're right. An idiot.
You really are.
I just found the first number I could find. All right,
All right, is it 850...
Yeah, you guys called me.
236-6000. All right, 850-236-6000, and that's room 2232. Now, that's a toll-free number, 850?
No, that's one of the Florida area codes.
Really? How weird. Florida, no wonder they hang off the bottom down there like a big penis. All right, so it's 850-236-6000, and then it's room 2232.
Yes.
Yeah.
I look forward to hearing from you guys all night tonight.
What are you talking about? We're not going to call you tonight.
Why would we call you? You got nothing but a gift basket.
All right, 850-236-6000, then it's room 2232. to talk to Wonder Boy.
All right.
Yeah, well, I look forward to that.
Hey, who just got a paying gig in radio.
And Tenacious C, I'm sure you'd get one, except for that Craig is a homo.
Damn.
You didn't know that?
No.
Yeah. You've been doing all the wrong things.
Oh, well.
Okay, that's okay. That's right, honey. You're going to get a little something extra special. All right, let me get this number down, though, for Wonder Boy. 850-236-6000.
Yes.
And that's room 2232.
Yes.
Right. That's the Marriott Bay where Wonder Boy is staying, a beautiful hotel. 850-236-6000.
Right.
Room 2232.
All right, we won't bother you unless we need you, Wonder Boy.
That sounds fair enough.
Okay,
unless it's an absolute emergency.
Right, then we'll just give you a quick call.
That sounds great.
At that number.
It's already ringing, guys.
Oh, God.
Do you want me to answer that and get back to you?
How many phones does this kid have?
He's got a bank of phones in front of him like he's got rocks. Whose baby is that? I'll buy that. What's your angle?
Got rocks. All right, kids. All right, have fun there, okay?
All right, thanks.
Thanks, guys.
Start working on these pictures.
You got it.
All right, and I'll give you a call at 850-236-
6,000.
6,000 in the room 2232.
2232, yeah.
All right, see you
later. All right, thanks.
All right, take care. Their assignment there at the Marriott Bay, 850-236-6000, room 2232, is to get pictures of girls flashing.
Right.
With the Ron and Fez logo in the picture, so we know they're legitimate.
Yeah.
And then 50 gets Wonder Boy, Joe Poo, and Rachel the Tenacious C 10 minutes of airtime to make a New York City air check. 100 gets them a whole break. One of Rachel flashing gets them 4 hours.
Now, I understand they're also doing time and temperature updates.
Oh, nice. Okay. Yeah.
And I don't know what it is about that Tenacious C. She's a dirty talker.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, if you call her at that number.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she's a dirty talker. 850-236-6000, and that's room 2232.
Right.
That should be exciting.
Now, we talked about Wonder Boy getting a gig in radio.
Yeah.
Getting a job. Ronnie found out about it.
Yeah.
And then Wonder Boy announced it to the group last night after the show. Stunned as anybody, Al Dukes.
Al Dukes, who should have been... bring Al in.
His supervisor.
Right.
Was not in the loop on this.
You can't come popping in here as gay as a cricket.
Here comes Al Dukes. If the management here was going to hire someone, a kid that worked directly under you, don't you think they would come to you and say, hey, how's this kid working out for you?
Yeah, I would have thought that. Instead, they came to me today and said, oh, by the way, we hired Wonder Boy.
They didn't come to you today. We told you last night.
Yeah, you guys told me last night, but today they came to me like I didn't know anything.
What'd you say?
I don't know anything. I said, yes, I heard from, Wonder Boy himself told me. No, I said, how does this work now? He's doing an internship. He's working here. And they said he will carry out his internship duties while he's doing this.
Well, he doesn't have to do that.
No.
Why would I make the kid do that?
Let him start his gig.
He made a commitment to the show. Here.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Finally, this show has something to be proud of.
So now you're trying to put the kibosh on it already.
He's also doing a thing. He's doing traffic in some town in Jersey. He's got a better career than you, Al, that quick.
Albert, not to hurt your feelings, but you have zero stroke here.
Yeah, that I should have been alerted to before this happened.
Everything.
That I agree about that.
You weren't even consulted on someone that you're in charge of. You should have been the make it or break it interview.
I agree.
And then we didn't even find out everybody else is taking vacations next week.
Yeah.
I don't let your chest up for that.
Yeah, I just found that out also.
Superstar knows everything before you.
And Joe Poo was just telling me last night, he's burnt out.
Really?
Yeah.
From what?
I have no idea. What is it, Joe?
I'm not burnt out.
You said you were just dead on your feet or something.
Just a little tired.
You said you were exhausted? You said you were dead on your feet.
Dragging my ass a little, yeah. Not burnt out. I have a couple years for that.
I think you're fried. I think you're absolutely fried. Now, see, Al, if you
Why can't they just dial him the room directly?
You need their full name in order
Ray
to
Wagner.
Get through.
Right. Wonder Boy's real name is Ray Wagner.
That's correct, yes it
is. So you can call Ray Wagner Wonder Boy. 850. Every time I go up to do that, he takes it off. 850-236-6000, room 2232, Ray Wagner.
Yeah, if you need to ask for Wonder Boy, ask for Ray Wagner. All right, 850-236-6000, room 2232 at the beautiful Marriott Bay Resort.
And today she'll see us in there. She'll talk dirty to you, I'm sure.
She can't help it.
Mm. Hey, Matt, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Matt.
Hey, you can't even call. The hotel is bombarded.
Everyone knows Tara Reid's staying there.
Yeah, right. At
the lady at the switchboard must be going nuts.
How the hell with her?
Her real name is Tara Wagner, if you want to ask.
It's spring break, world. Us kids are going crazy. I don't care. Kiss my ass, world. I'm a senior. Seniors rule. We're going all the way to the state. Well, that's high school. That's not college. Hey, Marty. Hardy, Marty, party. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, Marty.
Hey, listen, you can't get through. Everything's jammed up. But they did put me through the first time.
Yeah?
I just asked for 2232. Got right in.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. They answer on the phone, Ron and Fez, too.
What an idiot. What maroons?
Talk to you later.
All right.
Okay. So, again, you're calling the number, 850-236-6000, asking for Ray Wagner. In room 2232.
By the way, he's going to need his sleep tonight, so please don't call him during the late night hours.
Right.
That's his J-O time.
That's where he's ordering 4 to 6 minutes of in-room movies.
And, you know,
and
he's
turning it off.
He's going to be down there, and he's going to be, you know, hanging with the chicks, and all. They're going to go, well, what school do you go to, Wonder Boy? Columbia School Broadcast. kind of part of the whole Ivy League broadcasting series.
And if you wouldn't mind, would you hold this sign and flash for me?
Yeah.
How many pictures do you think they're going to come back with?
4.
Yeah.
2 of them are going to be of Wonder Boy's balls.
And he's going to try to pass those off as a woman's breasts.
He's going to paint nipples on his balls and say, I got this.
Uh-huh. And they're just going to be dangling over the Ron and Fez logo that he took with him.
And please don't put this number up on the website. 850-236-6000, room 2232. That's Ray Wagner, Wonder Boy.
That's where he's at. He loves to hear that song, Wonder Boy, if you want to sing that to him late in the night.
And then Tenacious C, she's staying in the room, too. She talks dirty. Wonder Boy. Hey, how you doing, man?
Hey, what's going on, boys?
Hey.
What's going on?
Yeah.
Easy.
Hey, you know what? I get out of work at 5 in the morning. Would that be a good time to call?
I think it is, because he's an early riser.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then I'll do that then.
All right, E.
All right, boy.
There you go.
You know what, E? Save up and get a whole name. You know, you don't want to go through life with just one initial.
You're a whole person. Have a whole name.
You think Madonna said, they go, what are your initials? M. Just yeah. M.
Hmm. Middle initial?
No. No.
Not even that much.
I just have an M.
That's all. She could get towels from the Marriott, and they would have her initial on them.
How about the power of flight? How's that sound to you? By the way, I think Jack Black might be staying in that room if you're a fan of the band. 850-236-6000. Your chance to talk to Tara Reid, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
2232. It's Ray Wagner's room.
Right. Now, the situation with Jack Black and Tara Reid,
they've
got a lot of press junket things to do tonight, a lot of things to get ready for tomorrow for the premiere, the screening there. So they're not going to get back to the room till really, really late.
Right.
All right? The wee hours, as they're known. So if you're going to call Ray Wagner, 850-236-6000.
That's Wonder Boy.
Uh-huh. Room 2232. You're going to have to wait till just about dawn to catch Tara Reid and Jack Black there.
They'll all be there. It'll be party time. It'll be going on all night. Hey, Rob. Rob, you're on Ron and Fez.
Oh, yeah. They'll be up.
What's up, guys? 2630 checking in. I got through to Wonder Boy's room. He answers the phone like a stupid tool. He's like, Ron Fez. I'm like, dude, you're not going to get any sleep tonight. He's like, yeah, no, they freaking gave out my number. Oh, he sounds really pissed off, man.
Yeah,
it's
right.
Be great.
He's enjoyed a nice night Call him back.
Why don't people start getting through and asking for Ray Wagner?
Well, you know what? At least he knows he's loved, you know?
I'd rather call and ask for Robert Wagner.
That's who you want. That's the room number we need.
Same room.
Really? I think that's his dad.
Okay, for free kittens, 850-236-6000, room 2232. That's Ray Wagner's room.
You can get a free kitty by calling there. Ask for Ray Wagner. He's in charge of cats, 850-236-6000, room 2232.
We'll take a break. We'll be right back. It's Ron and Fez.
1027 WNEW, New York.
We're Ron and Fez. We have sent the interns to Florida for spring break, Panama City. Wonder Boy and Rachel, the Tenacious C, are there. And actually, you can talk to them.
Well, that's nice, isn't it?
That's nice set up. They're at the Marriott Bay Resort. The number, 850-236-6000. As for Ray Wagner, that's Wonder Boy, room 2232.
Now, do any of you on Night House, please stay up just as late as you can and give him a call.
All right, good.
Because I believe there's a free psychic reading tonight.
Oh, nice.
850-236-6000, room 2232.
Okay. Now, also, if you have any information whatsoever on the JonBenet Ramsey case.
Right.
Any information on that whatsoever that you think might help authorities, please call this number, 850-236-6000. As for Ray Wagner, room 2232.
Fezzy, interracial phone sex. A brand new number for that. It's 850-236-6000. 2232 is the extension. As for Ray Wagner.
Okay, good. All right, nice. The big show in town this weekend in Panama City, Rick Springfield will be rocking the Panama City Beach area. You don't want to miss that show. For reservations and tickets, give this number a call. 850-236-6000. As for Ray Wagner,
room Ray Wagner,
2232. That's for tickets and reservations to Rick Springfield this weekend at Panama City Beach.
All your favorite hip-hop and R&B tunes. If you want them, your request will be taken. 850-236-6000, extension 2232. As for Ray Wagner.
All right, now, if you're concerned about your health, for a free colon cancer screening kit, here's the number you want to call.
Right, you have to fart into the phone.
Yeah, make sure. That way they'll test you that way. 850-236-6000. Ask for Dr. Ray Wagner, room 2232. All right, make sure you fart into the phone. That's for a free colon cancer screening kit.
Fezzy, We miss the kids. Our kids are down there. What are we saying? But look who's filling in for us tonight is our intern, Mikey D.
Hey, hi guys.
Mikey D. How you doing, buddy?
Hi, how are you?
We're cool.
Mikey D, 5-time Tony Award nominee.
Yeah.
That's correct.
As literally...
Gary, Indiana.
What a wonderful name.
Named for Albert Gary of judiciary fame. Gary, Indiana. As a Shakespeare would say.
Now, were you in the Music Man, Mikey D?
Yes, I was, with Ken Berry.
Nice!
And also in that production was Patrick Swayze.
Really?
Now, how old was Patrick Swayze?
Well, this was in 1974. He had a lower billing than I did.
Really?
So I had the higher billing. And I have a picture of him here. With
Let me see.
Oh, nice pictures! This is what I was waiting for.
Now, this is... Wow, look how fruity he looks.
Heavy on the makeup there, Patrick.
Yeah, he was. Now, you're the real little kid?
That's me.
Wow. What a cute kid. Now, why did the three of you pose like that?
I don't have any idea.
So you grew up a theater kid.
I was a little child actor, really well known for musicals. I did a lot of musicals.
Singing and dancing and all that stuff?
Singing and dancing, and I performed on the Ed Sullivan Show. And here's a picture of me and Ed Sullivan.
No way! I love this! Boy, I wish you still had these Music Man clothes that you could wear in here.
I think I do still have some of those clothes.
I'm a little nervous here. Look, Ed Sullivan getting a little handy with the kid.
Let's see.
It's a hearty hug.
Yeah, it's a little too much.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, you're getting, like you're Topo Gigio there.
Yeah.
The way you're getting used. The fist we're looking at. All right. Now that is Ed Sullivan. You're right there, buddy.
I'm right there, and also...
You look like you just want to get away from Uncle Ed Sullivan here.
He was pretty cool. He was
Ed
a pretty cool guy.
Ed Sullivan.
A really big shoe.
Ed Sullivan.
Also on that show was Liza Minnelli, who I know is getting married this weekend.
Yes.
Yeah. And anyway, she was really, really mean to me.
Really?
Wanted to take a picture. At that time, she wasn't by herself. She had a band.
Uh-huh.
And she would not take the picture with me, so I felt really bad, and I have a picture of her band here with me. And then finally, she wanted to...
Could somebody get over here and help out so we're reaching stuff? I hate to bother.
We have to walk away from the microphones to
I hate to
reach
bother everybody
here
with the show stuff.
Finally, she wanted to take a picture, and I just said, no, I don't want a picture with you anymore.
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, we met again at the Tony Awards.
You were precocious.
Yes, oh, yes.
You were a precocious child. Now, some of this stuff, it doesn't even look like you're having fun, though. It looks like you're almost forced into it.
Yeah, you're barely smiling in any of these things.
Well, I was a little upset about Liza at that point.
Sure, we all were. But, you know, I have to remember, she went through a lot of years where she enjoyed the pills.
Oh, yes.
Right.
Yeah.
She didn't know what she was doing.
There was, right down the block, here's another picture of me performing at the Carnegie Hall.
Wow.
Doing the old Fred Astaire tap dancing routine.
Now, can you still tap?
Oh, yeah.
Maybe we'll set up a little board in here and do a little tap.
Oh, that'd
be
cool.
Do that one time.
You still got shoes? Don't you have to have special shoes?
I still have the shoes, but they don't fit anymore.
No,
but,
sure.
So,
yeah.
Look at you and your top hat and tails putting on the Ritz.
That's true.
Just tapping away. That's cool. Now, Mikey D, this may be, this picture, I just started flipping through your photo album.
Please do.
That looks like Danielle Brisbois from Archie Bunker.
Absolutely. We had a little act that we did. We went to the Catskills.
You had an act with, Cousin Steffi.
Yes.
Wow.
From All in the Family.
Look how cute she was there, too.
Mm-hmm.
She was, Showstoppers was the act, huh?
And this was also... another Catskill act that I had called Me and My Shadow.
Oh, what do you do with a very young Earl Douglas?
I knew that was going to be said.
And my shadow.
I was the shadow.
That's good to see in blackface, Mikey D. That's hysterical.
Yeah. Well, this was Fezzy taken in 1860.
Oh, okay.
So we didn't know.
When it was then.
We didn't know. You were there with...
Our other interns have no Broadway experience whatsoever.
Right.
This is really cool, Mikey D.
If you flip through it a little, I also did Midsummer Night's Dream with Richard Gere, and that's in one of those albums there as well.
Oh, okay.
You'll see me and Richard there.
That must be the one Ronnie has there.
Yeah, hold on. I'm looking at some of these things. You were constantly dressing up as a street urchin.
Well, that's Oliver. That's Oliver with John Carradine.
Really?
And one of the kids in there, one of the Fagans kids, is one of my best friends. He is an Emmy Award winner.
What did he win his Emmy for?
For a thing called Unicorn Tales, which was, I think, in the late 70s.
Daytime Emmy?
A New York City Emmy.
Right? Oh, okay.
New York City Emmy.
It's a local Emmy.
And he performed at the White House as well in 1992.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, now... with all the young people you started out with there, who probably went on to be the most well-known?
Mikey D, interning for us tonight.
That's for sure. There's a lot that made it and did a lot after those few years, but they've just disappeared through the years.
Uh-huh.
The only guy that really, Richard Gere, is still doing stuff. And
how old was Richard Gere when you were working with him? Was he a kid actor? Or?
No, he was... It was just before, I think, American Gigolo.
Nice. So he's just about to break.
He was just about to break.
And what was the play?
Midsummer Night's Dream.
Oh.
At Lincoln Center.
A lot of good pictures of you and Ken Barry.
Oh, yeah.
And there's Angela Lansbury. She wrote.
She was really cool. Very cool woman.
You got a couple pictures with her. It looks like you were dating.
Yeah, sure. They hit it off good.
Well, during the Gypsy, we grow up after the first half an hour. And after that, we had nothing to do. She would always open up her trailer, and we used to go in a trailer and eat nuts and watch TV.
Is that what she called it?
That's what she called it.
Fez used to eat nuts, too.
when I was in Oliver. But with us, it was Oliver Hardy. I had the lead.
You know, just seeing these pictures reminded me my parents were crap. How about pushing me a little bit? Why let me sit in front of a TV through my whole childhood? Now, a lot of kids getting into drugs there, or you all stay clean?
Well, no, we got into drugs as we got older. That's what I think happened to a bunch of us. And, you know, once the cuteness runs out when you become like 15, 16.
Then you're hideous. You're all buck teeth and elbows.
You're done. You're done. Yeah. That's what happened.
Did you ever go on stage high?
All right, I still want to say the I have.
In Runaways, in Runaways, I was high.
This on the instant feedback, we're supposed to ask you about Shelley Bruce.
Okay, Shelley Bruce. She was in Music Man as well.
Now, who exactly is Shelley Bruce? So I don't know.
Shelley Bruce was, I think, the second Annie on Broadway.
Ah,
and the daughter of Lenny Bruce and Shelley Berman.
I wish.
She used to follow me around backstage, and she was the first girl I ever kissed the cooch, if I should say.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
Now, did she have the Annie hair there
Shelley
as well?
Shelley Bruce!
So what's happened to Shelley Bruce over the years?
She was an Annie. I believe she was diagnosed with leukemia. She fought it off, and you never heard of her again.
Wow, you think it was something you did? Messed it down?
Maybe. I don't know. I hope not.
Now, how old were you guys when you were kissing the cooch?
I was 11. I think she was 10.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the first one.
I'm still looking for the Richard Gere pick. Somebody help me.
That must be somewhere here. I'll
there's two of those. Okay. Yeah.
No, these guys will help you.
Yeah.
Just pass them over to me.
Everyone knows who Richard Gere is, right?
Yeah.
There we are.
So they know what to look for.
And Michael Sacks as well, who was in Sugarland Express with Goldie Hawn. He's there, too. He was in the same production.
Wow, look at the young, gay Richard Gere.
Is that pre-Gerb?
Yes. Pre-Gerb. He used to lie to me, too. We were backgammon partners for that when we were doing the production.
Uh-huh.
And he has a birthmark on his back.
Uh-huh.
And he used to tell me that he was an Indian prince, and that was like a... some sort of mark as the Indian prince, but as
you're
grew
lucky
up,
you didn't leave a mark in you.
Yeah, well, we were sharing the same dressing room, so I am lucky.
All right, now I'm hearing, what's the Rob Lowe story?
The Rob Lowe story. I shouldn't say that. That could get me in trouble.
Really?
Yeah.
Sniz? I just cough. I'll say things and you cough, okay?
Okay.
Sniz? Gay stuff.
Wow. Were you that chick at the 88 Democratic Convention?
That's another story. That's another story that I know. And,
Wow.
Yeah.
That's exciting stuff.
That I don't want to get into.
Please. Well, don't make you a bad person. You get a little high and
you know.
Fool around with the guys. What's the big deal?
All right.
Hey, by the way, if you want to hear more of these stories, it's 850-236-6000, room 2232, Ray Wagner.
Yeah, make sure you ask for Ray Wagner.
And the later you call, the better, folks.
Yeah.
He knows all the stories.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He'll let you know, we can't say on the air, what happened with Rob Lowe and Mikey D. Mm. But if you want to find out, if you want to know the whole story, call this number, 850-236-6000. Ask for Ray Wagner's room. That's room 2232.
All right, so what got you off the Broadway thing? You just hit that age?
You know, I started when I was 3, and by the time I was 16, we were doing Runaways, and it just deteriorated from there.
What kind of school did you go to?
Well, I went to public school, and then as I got older, I went to High School of Performing Arts, and then I went to a professional school, and the professional school... Believe it or not, I was with Lawrence Fishburne, Ralph Carter, Vincent Spano. We all went to the same school.
Ralph Carter from Good Times?
That's correct.
Hey, Fezzy, Vincent Spano grew up on Roosevelt Island, too.
Right,
really?
Exactly. Yeah. Used to go visit him.
Cool.
Yeah,
I think he was in the 400 building. I don't know. I'm making all that up.
Well, me and Larry used to do Hits a Mesk
and
go up and down the hallways and sing Happiness is a Warm Gun. I remember that.
All right, really now, you're allowed to tell that story, but you can't tell the other one.
I know.
Now,
how horrible could the Rob Lowe story be?
Now, well, Larry Fishburne was like 14 when he was in Apocalypse Now.
That's correct. He had done that already when we were at school together. And he was a year older than I was, so he graduated the year before I graduated.
Yeah.
But we kept in touch, and we've seen each other.
Really?
Since, yeah, yeah.
Try to get him on the show tomorrow night. You can interview him. As many people as you get on, that can all be your interviews tomorrow night.
Yeah, okay. Let him know you got a radio show in New York.
I'll put out some feelers.
Yeah, yeah. Put out some feelers.
Why not?
You know, by the way, Rory, you look like crap to me now. Seriously. You used to be the name dropper. You're nobody to me.
You got nothing. You're solid
big
gold
deal,
tennis court.
Your dad's a judge.
I was in a play when I was in high school.
Blah, blah, blah. Mm. No one was in it with you.
That's the problem. What happened to you?
You had every advantage. Nothing.
I'm going to start pushing my kids. I'm going to push them. Make them do things.
Yeah. I just now got to see the Richard Gere picture.
Yeah.
That's great. He's in a big, poofy, open shirt.
I know.
And a very young Mikey D, just topless, wearing a little, you know...
Well, I was a fairy.
Pan thing. A little Midsummer Night's Dream there.
I was one of the fairies.
Now, did they treat you like a co-worker, or did they treat you like a kid?
They were all really cool.
Yeah.
I actually have a tape, too, with Patrick doing a Donald Duck impersonation for me.
Yeah.
And he used to ride a motorcycle a lot, so he used to take me out on the motorcycle, and we used to go...
He was an older guy, right?
Yeah, he was an older guy. Yeah. I mean, he must have been in his early 20s at the time.
And he studied ballet. Was he doing that then?
He had a ballet ache.
Well, that's what he was in the show.
He had a bad ballet ache.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Ooh. That sidelined the dancing career.
No, that's what he was one of the dancers of the show in Music Man. So that's why I had the higher billing, because I was, of course, Winthrop Peru.
You had a character.
That's right.
Nice. That's what I need, Fez. I need my own character.
And... Again, actually, I was...
Oh, you got reviews?
Well, I was critiqued.
All right, pass the reviews over.
In Music Man.
Nice. Now, what were your Tony nominees?
Okay, the Tony nominees...
Nominations, excuse me.
We were Best Musical.
That was Runaways.
Runaways. It's all from the same show.
Oh, okay.
All five were from the same show.
All the same year.
All the same year.
Oh, okay.
Right.
So the show got five nominations.
Well, this was the deal. We, as a cast, were all nominated. So
okay.
Every one of us, once we won, if we won, we're all going to come on stage and accept the award. But, of course, Nell Carter won it all.
Ain't misbehaving.
That's correct. And
all right, here's your review. Do you know what paper this is out of, by the way?
I think it was a local jersey, because it was at
Herald
the
News,
Playhouse.
Yeah. It says, one of the best moments in the play when a young Mikey D, as the lisping Winthrop Peru, sings Gary, Indiana. So you had kind of the kid lead in that film.
That's
correct.
On
that play.
Yep.
Why no film work for you?
I did do some film work.
Oh, really?
I was in The Godfather.
Really?
And it's interesting because...
You were Clemenza.
Yeah.
You were good.
Yeah, I know.
Scary.
I was actually in one of the scenes with Al Pacino, and I just got that on DVD where you can actually stop the frame and see my face right there.
Finally, the technology is caught up to the
park. I've got the DVD too. What part do you know?
It's when Al Pacino and Diane Keaton are coming out of, I think it's Saks Fifth Avenue. It's supposed to be Saks.
Yeah.
And there's three kids in front of the store. Now, it's winter time, and I don't know why they did this.
This is just as they were finding out, it was right before they found out that his dad got shot, right?
It was just before his dad got shot,
right.
Yeah,
I know that scene. Like, I'm walking out with presents, so what were you doing?
I'm in front of the store, and again, they were throwing fake snow with these big fans. They had me in shorts, running around, kicking a ball, kicking like a can.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, I'm right by the door as Al Pacino and Diane Keaton come out, and I'm... There I am, just looking right in the camera. I don't know if I was supposed to do that, but I'm there.
And can you see that you're wearing shorts?
Yeah, because before they come out, they're showing the kids playing on the street, and there I am in those shorts.
You're in the street playing scene two?
I'm in the scene
all right.
Playing, and then as they come out, then you see me again by the door.
Okay, so that's the first Godfather.
That's the first Godfather.
Wow.
That beats the hell out of Paulo's Caddyshack story.
There you go.
That he keeps throwing in our fat faces.
I'm tired of that Caddyshack crap. Paulo's a mutt.
I was in The French Connection as well.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, yeah. My gosh. Any film that didn't win an Oscar.
That's right.
Yeah, all
Both
Oscars.
Best pictures.
Yeah, it's like one year after another, too.
Gene Hackman was a real cool guy.
You did a scene with Gene Hackman?
Yeah,
let me guess. You were the kid kicking the ball.
By the way, if you're interested in free DVDs, I got a lead on a guy. It's 850-236-6000, extension 2232. Ask for Smoke and Ray Wagner.
Okay.
And that's a 24-hour line.
All right. So that number, 850-236-6000.
Yeah.
Room 2232, Ray Wagner, Smoke and Ray.
Better after 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
After 2 a.m.
Yeah, you're probably sure to get through at that point. So what did you do with Gene Hackman?
Okay,
the French Connection?
He's coming back. This is when that French guy is on the roof shooting at him as he's coming back to his apartment. I'm in the background, and the guy shoots me by mistake, and you see me fall off a rock.
Really?
You get shot?
I get shot in it. Yep, I get shot. You see me fall off a rock. They actually had these. It was old times, so I mean, they had these little blood packets in me with wires running through me. So there was a guy on the side that would just press the button, and the thing would.
Wait a minute. I know the name for that. It's something like splivs, or
I don't remember.
I know this from watching the Godfather documentary thing, because the most ever was in the Tobu scene.
Oh, okay.
Oh, with James Caan, right?
Yeah, with James Caan. So it's got a name. You know what? Get Billy in here. Billy might know.
Staples now.
Billy, do you know the name of this I'm looking for?
What's that?
When you got the exploding blood things on you, it's called like a spliff or a spit.
A spiff.
No, not a spiff, but
a spliff.
It's something very, very close to that.
Yeah,
a squib.
Squib. They
a
explode.
Squib. That's what it is. That was a squib.
Good work, Billy.
Yeah, Billy.
Anytime.
Jeez.
Smoking weed, smoking whiz, doing coke, drinking beers, rolling baddies, smoking blunts, who smokes the blunts, who smokes the blunts?
Gotta take a break. We'll be right back with more Broadway and film talk with Mikey D. 877-692-1027 is the Ron and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez.
You're scaring me. Stop it.
1027 WNEW.
We're Ron and Fez. Guest intern tonight, Mikey D.
Huh?
Five-time Tony Award nominee. Giving us some Broadway war stories right now. Oh, by the way, the movie that Paul O reviewed earlier, Ice Age?
Yeah.
That opens in theaters everywhere tomorrow. For showtimes and theaters in your location, call this number, 850-236-6000. That's 850-236-6000. As for Ray Wagner, room 2232, that's for showtimes and theaters.
By the way, Fez, you want to see pictures of Nadia Comaneci naked.
Really? The Olympic gold medalist. The only person to ever score a perfect 10, right?
Yes.
The gymnast?
Yes, she was so cute. 850-236-6000, extension 2232. As for Crazy Ray Wagner.
All right, nice.
For those naked Nadia Comaneci pictures.
Also, we want to pass out this number, too, for a trial issue of Blue Boy Magazine. What you want to do is ask for Blu-ray Wagner, 850-236-6232. That's Blu-ray Wagner. For a trial subscription to Blue Boy Magazine.
Hey, if you're interested in the KKK,
right?
You'll want to talk to the Grand Wizard, Ray Wagner. Here's the number, 850-236-6000. Extension 2232. Just tell him, hey, I'm ready to kill an N.
All right, now, to become a member of Dungeons & Dragons, apparently the meeting's been changed. For information, you're going to want to call Sir Ray Wagner, 850-236-6000. That's room 2232, Sir Ray Wagner, Minister of Darkness. That's to become a member of Dungeons & Dragons and to get more information on when they meet.
Fezzi, if you're looking for signed naked pictures of Vida Blue, here's the phone number, 850-236-6000, room 2232. Ask for Ray Wagner.
All right, that's good.
Have an idea for a new flavor for Ben & Jerry's ice cream?
Ooh.
I've got a phone number for you. 850-236-6000, 2232. You want to call after 3 a.m. on that one. Ask for Ray Wagner.
Now, for a complimentary copy of the video Monkeys in Heat, you want to call Gorilla Ray Wagner, at 850-236-6000. That's room 2232 at that number.
Fezzy, I've got a lead on free vodka, pizza, and crack horse.
All right, go ahead.
850-236-6000, 2232. As for Ray Wagner.
Now, if you're bothered at night, trouble with anal polyps, what you want to do is call Backside Ray Wagner at 850-236-6000. That's room 2232. He's there to help.
If you're fat and smelly and have trouble finding a friend, call Ray Wagner. 850-236-6000, 2232 is the number there.
Also, we want to pass this along, if we could at this time. If you can't find your baby's daddy, you want to call Ray Wagner. The name Ray Wagner, 850-236-6000. That's room 2232.
If you need free computer software, 850-236-6000, 2232 is the extension. Ask for Mr. Ray Wagner.
Now, do you suffer from gum pain?
Yeah.
Do your teeth hurt?
Yes, they do.
Call Ray Wagner, DDS.
And just bitch at him.
Mm-hmm. At 850-236-6000. That's room 2232 for Ray Wagner, DDS.
Ghostbusters. 850-236-6000. Extension 2232. As for Ray Wagner, he's ready to believe you.
Who are you going to call? Ray Parker Wagner.
Hey, Sean. Sean, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Sean.
Hey, what's going on, boys?
Yeah.
Buddy?
You know, I just heard if you want to join the Rosie O'Donnell fan club,
yeah,
you can call their leader. It's 1-850-236-6000. Ray Wagner's his name, 2232.
Thank you very much. Mm-hmm.
Appreciate that. We'll pass that information along.
Hey, Carlos. Carlos, you're on Ron and Fez.
Carlos.
Hey, what do you say, boys?
Hey, buddy.
Buddy?
Hey, buddy.
What's going on?
Hey, buddy.
Well, if you need a gay lover late at night,
uh-huh,
you could call 850-236-6000 and ask for Wonder Boy. Fezzy say hey.
Fezzy say hey. Hey, Carlos.
So you know what I'm thinking, Fezzy?
What's that?
Me, you, and Mikey D, we get together and we do one more play.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
We do a Glengarry Glen Ross.
All right.
We do The Odd Couple, only with three people this time. Something.
One guy who's not really all that sloppy.
Right.
But not all that neat either, mister. The Odd Trio. I'm in.
Me too.
Seriously, I'd love to get back on the boards. Whether it's acting or basketball. I just want to be on the boards. I like the fact that somebody had a great childhood, Fuzzy, when I was in the dullest possible place.
And what's so nice, you have all these memories, I Mikey know. D.
Yes, many memories.
You got the photos, you got the reviews. The golden child. Oh, by the way, for free meat, call Ray Porkchop Wagner, 850-236-6000. That's room 2232. Free meat.
If you want to give Osama bin Laden a piece of your mind, it's 850-236-6000. I guess that's where he's staying.
Uh-huh.
Room 2232. He's staying under the name Ray Wagner.
Okay. Oh, and by the way, for a free transcript of tonight's show, call Ray Wagner. He's not going to have anything he can mail out, but he'll give it back to you word for word. The transcript of tonight's show, 850-236-6000. Room 2232.
We recommend that you call late and call often.
Mm-hmm. Please. Make sure your call goes through.
Fezzy, how late do you stay up at night?
Lately, last night I was up to like 3:30. And that's a rarity for me. I try to be in bed and make myself go to sleep no later than 1.
By make yourself go to sleep, you're talking about with pills?
No, I lay down and I close my eyes, I turn off the TV, and I make myself go to sleep.
I do the same thing, only with pills.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That seems to be the way to go.
Yeah, it's the comfortable way to sleep.
That's perfect. I'm using my thunderstorm machine. I have a machine that now controls the weather.
This is one of those sound machines.
Uh-huh. Right.
So what all do you have on there?
I got Thunderstorm. I got the
I
ocean.
I have Thundercats on mine.
Really? How do you sleep?
Thunder, Thundercats.
I got the ocean. I got the forest meadow. And I wanted white noise, but I actually got black noise on mine.
Yeah.
A lot of sirens and that sort of thing, and just people screaming.
I have one that sounds like just a sound. It's a little sound machine. Helps you sleep. It sounds like a woman being gangbanged by 10 bikers.
Oh, okay.
And it just goes on and on, and finally I just drift off.
And that helps you?
Well, yeah, because I'm hiding. Like, what if they see me?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the longer I stay down there, the more apt I am to just doze off and sleep peacefully.
That. Whatever gets you to sleep, that's what I say.
That's the important thing, isn't it?
Because you need your sleep.
You gotta have.
By the way, if you've never had a man say, I love you, to you before, here's the number you want to call. 850-236-6000. As for Ray, I love you, Wagner, room 2232. That's if you've never had a grown man say to you, I love you.
Mm.
Call that number.
Call later the better.
Mm-hmm.
I probably won't even start calling until 3. That's the beauty of it.
Yeah. That way you're sure to get through.
All right. Now, tomorrow night, Fuzzy, we got Mikey D coming in. Why don't we do something where you and Mikey D do a song together, a Broadway song?
Ah, I love it. I'm in.
Okay, me too.
What would be a good song?
What could we do?
Mikey
D, I'm going to have to leave this in your hands.
What about whole I'd do anything for you, dear thing, where it's always it's a call and response? It's from Oliver.
Oliver, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Or Consider Yourself.
Consider Yourself Our Mate. That's good.
That's nice.
I think I'll do anything for you. That's a good one.
Okay.
To anything for you, dear.
Anything.
You got to say it like this. Anything.
Anything.
No, anything. I do
anything.
It like, anything. I do it like Jack Wilde, who was fabulous.
Oh, he's good.
Yeah, he's great.
Went on to H.R. Puffin stuff.
Anything for you, dear. Anything. The girls liked him. Here's Thane. Thane, you're on Manifest.
Hello, Thane.
Hi, guys.
Come back, Thane.
Yeah, I'm here.
Thane.
Hey, big ass card holder number 12266.
Yeah.
Anyway, do you want to talk to Santa Claus? Care of Ray Wagner, you call 850-236-6000, room 2332.
Oh, jeez.
All right, that's good to know. We will pass that along to the listeners.
Hey, Mark, you're on Runifest.
Hello, Mark.
Hey, boys, big ass card holder number 10591. Yeah, I just called Ray Wagner for the Free Monkeys in Heat video, and they told me that Mr. Wagner had to check out because he was receiving too many phone calls. They asked him to leave.
It's the first time he's ever been called Mr. Wagner in his life. Now, Fezzy, if you guys are going to do that tomorrow night, I'd like to see you and Mikey D in tights, too.
Oh.
And let's
I was going to wear them anyway.
Yeah, I know. It's Friday. Let's get the grease paint on both of you, and let's just really, you know.
Let's do it right.
Yeah.
Why half-ass?
Let's get some sawdust. 5 minutes, Mrs. Wadley!
That would be perfect. Oh, the smell of the crowd, the roar of the grease paint.
I don't know, I think you got that backwards.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. All right.
Oh, by the way, there's a brand new Opie and Anthony FU line.
Yeah?
It's 850-236-6000, extension 2242. Ask for Ray Wagner. Mikey D, terrific stuff tonight.
Thank you.
I really liked it. You got more pictures tomorrow?
Oh, sure. I have a lot of more stuff.
Bring a lot more stuff tomorrow, and I really want to see you and Fez, you know, have the sheet music, whatever we need here.
Yeah.
To do a real Broadway number together.
Okay.
That'll be fun.
Yeah.
And see who you can book from your childhood.
By the way,
what I can do.
When you look at Fez, I want to have people know he did do legitimate theater once. He played Mr. Ensign Pulver.
Yes.
And the great Mr. Roberts, and won accolades.
Got great reviews in the Pensacola News Journal.
All right.
That's true. That's a true story.
With his picture, too.
Uh-huh.
And he looked four. He looked like the four-year-old.
They put a four-year-old in the Navy. Oh, by the way, suffering from painful corns?
Yes, I am.
Help is available.
Yeah.
Call 850-236-6000. That's 850-236-6000. Ask for Ray Wagner, the foot doctor, room 2232.
By the way, if you'd like to speak to a dead relative, we've got a number for you, 850-236-6000. Extension 2232. Ask for Ray Wagner. And one last thing, kids.
I know now that joking with fecal matter is never justified.
I couldn't be said better myself.
Remember that. If you need help with that situation, if you find yourself joking around with fecal matter and you need help, 850-236-6000. Ask for Ray Poo Poo Wagner, room 2232.
We'll be back tomorrow, folks.
At 7 o'clock, right after Opie and Anthony.
See ya. See ya.
Sit.
Sit.
Ron and Fez, 1027 WNEW.
And EW.